Welcome to the cat, made us a plan, stuck to the goal. Keep it 100, that's a G code. Got it out the mud, watch the grass grow. True to the shit, you ain't seen this before. Man, we made us a plan, stuck to the goal. Keep it 100, that's a G code. Got it out the mud, watch the grass grow. True to the shit, you ain't seen this before.
Oh yeah, man, y'all already know what it is, man. We live right now, man. Mackin and Trapper Podcast with your boy Love Bone, man. We still talking shit, swallow spit, you know how it already go, man. This ain't no rehearsal nothing like this, man. We do this shit on the daily. You know what I'm talking about? That's what we call it, Mackin and Trapper. Right now, man, I got some special guests in here today, man. It's going down, man. Some of my player partners, homeboys, brothers, long time grind. Man, y'all already know what it is, man. It's going down like this. Y'all already know them from their own radio show. You know what I'm talking about? Party Punch Radio Show. And I'm talking about DJing coast to coast with this shit. Promotion, man. This man hit all type of shit. I ain't got any name after his list. You know what I'm talking about? My big dog got his anniversary coming up. Hope y'all line up to perform, come do your thing, man. One time, man. 49 years of putting in work. You know what I'm talking about? It's going down, man. We making the traffic. I got the one and only DJ Prince side this motherfucker to my motherfucking left, man, as y'all can see. And I got the goddamn OG face on this side, man. Showing y'all we do this shit, man. It's going down Mackin and Trapper style, man. What's happening, fella?
You already know. Before we get into it, let me break it down a little bit better. I appreciate that. I hope to make it to 49 years.
My was 39.
No. What it is this 1973, hip hop was created.
Oh.
So August 11th and Cedric Ave Projects, August 11th. But we're celebrating the 49th anniversary of hip hop.
Yes, sir.
Hip hop has been around for 49 years, and hip hop has been acknowledged to everybody. And we're bringing the DJs, we're bringing the MCs, we have beatboxers, we have graffiti artists, and we have break dancers that's going to be out there with us as well as yourself in the stage.
Yes, sir.
And that's an honor and a pleasure. The Party Punishers and Kevin Glover from Connected. We together and we're going to do this. What's popping up?
Man, you already know, man. Still talking shit while I spit, man. Hanging out with Kevin Fast Lane, brother.
That's it.
No, what's up, man? Tell me who you is, man. Come on,
man. I know what it is, man. OG of the city, OG face guy, the AKA Ram Face. You know, when I go to Salvation, because I'm your baby mama, your mama, and your grandmama's favorite pastor. Have mercy.
Hey, for real, man. So we going, man. We cool, man. We going to get it in, man. So we 49 years of hip hop.
Right. Yep. 49 years.
So hip hop is young as shit, man. It's only 50 years.
Man, it was crazy, man. Though. Hip hop then took over the world globally.
Globally. You can't sell cereal without hip hop.
You can't sell oodles and noodles without hip hop. You can't.
So I had to say hip hop ain't shit, man. This shit is crazy.
It's
the youngest.
Yeah, you know, it's the youngest. The youngest genre of music, but it's took over
everything.
Everything. If you go to Asia, you got somebody doing some hip hop. You go to Africa, it's hip hop.
Yep.
You know, you go to any continent on the world, it's some hip hop influence somewhere.
And the crazy part about it is, with hip hop, you can go all over the world, like Fitz said, all over the world. They don't understand English, but they can speak your song word for word.
And that's just fucking amazing, man. That's damn amazing.
And that's the power of hip hop, man. And they wanted to abolish hip hop and get rid of it. And look at it. Everybody was against it at first, you know, banned in the USA and all of that, you know, but shit. Now look.
Still ticking. They're still trying to kill it. They can't stop it.
They can't stop what was intended to run the world.
Right.
You got to think about it. Hip-hop been in the White House.
Yep. Damn, so did.
Hip-hop been in the White House. Run DMC. Eazy-E. Yes, come on, all these cats performed, chilled, ate dinner with different, Snoop Dogg ate dinner with different presidents in the White House. This is hip hop.
Goddamn right.
I remember when my mother told me, boy, stop playing that mess. I don't want to hear that. So I would go outside, I'd get into trouble. But when she bought me my first turntables in 1979, I stayed in the house. She was content. If that's gonna make that boy stay in the house, stay out of trouble.
Yes.
Look how many people that hip hop saved their lives.
Yeah.
Hip hop has taken lives.
I mean, jobs are all being
provided. Hip hop has taken lives, but it saved more lives. Okay. And like you said, look how many people was coming out of penitentiary, but their mans got on and was giving them jobs.
Giving them jobs,
yeah.
And they got to go through none of that bullshit and all the other shit. You can't, you know what I'm saying? This is what you do, bro. You with me all day.
You with me. And my whole thing is, you good with math, with making the other product shape, well, I'm product. Well, I make me
you
shape.
You make me shape. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. It ain't nothing but a hustle.
That's but a hustle. And that's what you got to do, man. And shit. And so, we 49 years of hip-hop.
Right.
And Carolina still ain't got a good year in yet. Cause we ain't hit yet. We still ain't hit yet.
No, we ain't hit. Carolina ain't hit. We only got three mainstream artists really. Carolina. That's Moray. That's
Yeah, Moray popping.
Yeah, Moray.
We got Moray J. Cole, baby.
That's it. That's really three.
What about that?
Yeah, Black Zach, he's starting to bubble a little bit down there in South CAC, but North CAC artists is only really three artists that's doing the on a major right now.
It's four. Because if you think about
that's it, anytime?
He in his own lane, De Niro Ferrar sold out a concert. I've seen it with my own eyes.
Yeah.
Brother West right now.
Yeah, with the cult rap and all that. Like that. That's that Tech N9ne type stuff. Like, Tech N9ne owns everything of his, and they be talking about that's their own thing, but they pack houses. They turn out good. The Niro Ferrar catalog and his videos is ridiculous.
Yeah, the Niro.
He fine.
Niro, man.
Yeah, but right now, you know, and shout out to S. Dub, too, because I just seen he
got a new shout out to Dre.
Yeah, you ain't really from the floor.
Yeah, shout out to Dre, man.
Shout out to Dub.
Now, you say Rhapsody?
Rhapsody, Raleigh.
Rhapsody, yeah.
She's a beast.
Matter of fact, that's my Cordae from Carolina.
Who?
Cordae from North Carolina, from here. From West Salem, I think.
Yeah, so we starting to bubble.
I mean, Carolina got some people knocking on the door now.
You know, Lil Jubelli with the freestyling, you know.
And we got our last name. That's our King Carter's son. With the Tootsie.
Tootsie.
Yeah, we're coming to this. We ain't got there, we need to do it.
Yeah.
We should have been there, but you know.
Yeah.
Should have been there.
But God got his own timing.
That's why I tell people, everything happens for a reason.
Oh, yeah.
Everything happens when it's supposed to happen, not when you want it to happen.
You got that shit right. So 49 years, fellas. So you've been DJing shit.
I've been DJing since 1979. I got 43 years in.
Damn, you're right. They had the bird, player.
I got 43 years in. I started.
Dope as a motherfucker, man.
Yeah, I started in a project called Riverview Towers, where I grew up at in Paterson, New Jersey. My first influence of hip hop was in a project that was right across the street called CCP Projects.
Yeah.
Like, one day, you know, you're outside at 10, 11 years old and you hear this music coming from outside. Oh, what's the big speakers? And you see a big crowd, so I went over there. You know, I went over there and to see two dudes on the mic. They was doing their thing, and the DJ behind, he got two records repeating the beats. He's taking those two records, and he was being a whole band. And then he's cutting the records, and I'm like, I was amazed. And I'll never forget those dudes was called Kid Flash and the Almighty Fly MCs.
That's what they do.
They was called Kid Flash and the Almighty Fly MCs. And one dude name was Flaheem Ray Vaughn. And I remember telling Ray Vaughn that he was a star to me. And he was like, man, go ahead. He was like, and I asked him what it was. And he was like, this is hip hop. Because I always thought he was one of the coolest dudes because he was from Rum Projects, but he was dating a girl in my project.
Yeah.
And so, you know, time went on. It was about a year and a half in. And I never forget, I rapped for his girlfriend. I was like, tell Flaheem I'm coming. So she thought it was cute. Right. Mm-hmm. She thought it was cute. So I was coming out of the building one day with my mother. And you know, you with your mom, so you like, you know, because your mom was like, and I remember Tracy doing on Flaheem. And he was like, yeah, he was like little Charlie B bad. And she named him Charlie. I'm like, Charlie B, I am. Mm-hmm. She was like, little Charlie B bad, he on your ass. So he was like, let me hear some. And I looked at my mom's, and my mom's was like, go ahead, get it. So that gave you like,
yeah.
And I spit my little rhyme. And he was like, all right, my man, you good. So at 11, I started, but I never forget, one of my biggest climaxes was 13. I was 13. And I was at the Cold Crush Brother versus the Force MCs.
Wow.
That was at CCP Rec. I was there. I was hip hop then. Kango, British Walkers. Nice. I was all in then.
They're called British Walkers.
Yeah. British Walkers.
Like, okay,
they were like before Wallabies.
Yeah. Okay.
You see me wearing something.
Yeah, okay.
So, you know, I'm all out there, Lee suit, my jean suit, all airbrushed up and chilling. And Flaheem and them was on stage. And they was rocking. I mean, they was rocking. And you never forget the first time. Flaheem was like, yo, I got my man, my little homeboy. He's like, Charlie B, come on up here. They hit it. I start rapping. Everybody was crazy. I'm like, man, you can rap. Everybody went crazy. And then my man's, that I love him to death, DJ Cool T. Now that's the DJ. He was like, yo, I heard you could cut too. And they let me, you know, cut, let me cut from there. It was on it popping.
That's what it did.
It was on it popping. Like, it was, and people that know me was like, yo, it went crazy. Like, it was people. I battled KRS-One before KRS-One. Like, we was in New York, we was doing it.
That's classic shit, man.
I battled King's Son. Me and King's Son used to get it. Like, I battled cats. I battled Kool Moe
Dee. Only back in traffic, man. Classic shit, man.
I battled Kool Moe Dee. 1986, Hinks Cliff Stadium. Never forget it. Like I said, I got some drugs under my belt. And,
got some more to put up under there?
Yeah, I ain't done. I just, like, the rapping, I still got it. I love that. I just keep that as a secret weapon. But like rocking a party, it ain't nothing like rocking a party. But I come from the era of my most monumental moments. And a lot of people might go, why? I come from the era of being a DJ behind rap groups.
Yeah.
I just think that I'm a master of that. Like, man, a lot of blessing how Jam Master Jay was.
Right.
Jam Master Jay was the master of Run DMC. They could say, I want to do this, but your DJ reads the crowd.
Yeah, yeah.
And me and you been together many shows where I've changed the whole entire show.
He changed the whole set. And went from the bottom to the top. I don't care if I say this shit, you're like, nah, nigga, hold up.
Nah. But the fact of it,
I appreciate works. That shit. Yeah, it worked. You got my money. All right, they talk only. Take money to go.
And I like to tell cats, it's good to have show mixes, but when you a group's DJ, have the individual song too. Because in a show, because with a show mix, you gotta go according to the show mix.
Right.
But if you got individual songs, you can go all over that moment, like boom, 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 and you did the same show, but just in a different format.
Right.
And I tell a lot of groups, I tell a lot of people, get you a DJ. Get your personal DJ. Now it don't matter. It's all right sometimes if the artist go out and do a venue.
You think some of the artists even want to get the gigs by them? Like, I think they so to the point where they just want to rap. You know what I'm saying? So thinking straight. Even the DJ, from a DJ point of view, because I'm saying there's a lot of DJs out here now. Why they don't think they try to reach out to artists?
Because do that? A lot of artists don't like to share the spotlight. See, when we was coming up, it was the DJ name and then the artist name. You feel where I'm coming from?
Yeah.
It was Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five, DJ Easy Lee and the Treacherous Three, Charlie Chase, Tony Tone, and the Cold Crush Brothers.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? At the 90s came, let's go to the best one of hip hop, DJ Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince. Let me say what killed the DJ. And this is honest. Hip hop destroyed is my top dog. Because guess what? I'm your DJ, but when you go to do a song in the studio, all I get to do is sit there. You doing all the work.
True.
So record labels go what we need him for.
Gotcha.
A lot of DJ names not even on the record.
Technology's switched up a whole lot of stuff.
Right. Mm-hmm. So now, but this is where we go back. Now, people, like, I'm going to say Houdini. Houdini was the first who did it. You know, their DJ was Grandmaster D. Houdini said, okay, listen, we going in, we're going to take D from in front, and we're just going to be Houdini. So when they signed this Houdini, they all three signed in the group because they told them, our DJ is part of this group.
What's that mean?
Because when we go on tour, okay, we got to make a record, but how do we recoup the money? Going out there. Record sales, they don't just recoup all the money.
Right.
So they had to go out there, boom, recoup the money. Now you need your DJ. But the sad part is your DJ ain't getting none of the, only DJ that's getting money off of the labels was Houdini and Mathematics. Wu-Tang DJ, they stood by their DJ.
So most of the DJs are right now doing shows and stuff like that. They doing like, what do you call it, work for hire contracts? They're not doing, you know,
yeah, they just doing like, work for hire.
Why you think that's something? Why wouldn't the artists, they said, that's how you're doing your shows and shit, why not go ahead and include them in it, you know what I'm saying?
And then if you look, well, that's the, I don't even know.
That's what you begin to show. I mean, that's what you
get. You do the artist behind, because the DJ, like he said, when they put the music out, they ain't going to put them on a full-fledged contract unless you're a show enough DJ. And now the mixtape DJs, you don't even hear that no more because we ain't got the damn mixtapes no more.
Right.
You know, you got Spotify, Apple, all of that, then. You know,
man, you bring that shit back, man. Cause think about it. You ain't shit without DJ.
Yeah,
you gotta have DJ. Cause this will break the record. Right? I think that's what a lot of artists feel like with Pop too. They feel like they're gonna break the record someone.
Right. But they, and I tell artists all the time, cause they try to follow that with DJs. And I'm like, y'all follow that with the DJs in these clubs. Where y'all going to do your showcases or open mics or whatever you want to call it. You can't follow that with them DJs. Cause them the ones that's getting booked. Going to this club, going to that club, and if they fool with you and like your music, they gonna play it in different clubs. So now you got different people clicking on your stuff.
Right.
You know, but once you start falling out with the DJs, as they want to call them local DJs, they're the ones who start really breaking your record up.
Right.
And they do. But see, I want people to understand, and I'm glad you brought us up here. We're talking about hip hop.
Yeah.
I know both of y'all movie connoisseurs. I'm around you guys. Let's say Cadillac Records, let's say the Temptations movie, let's say the Five Heartbeats. We're all familiar with that, right?
Right.
Okay. Hip hop is the only genre who feels that they don't owe nobody nothing back. We feel that we are above everything. Now, while I'm getting at those three movies, in each one of those movies I named, it was a scene where somebody from the record label walked up in a DJ booth or in a radio station with the record, broke some payola. Could you play that?
That's still going on.
It's still going on. But hip hop feels, Nah, you just gonna play Hunter.
You talking about your boy?
No, I'm not even getting that hustle anymore. But look at back then, that country didn't mind paying, R&B didn't mind paying, Doo-Wop didn't, you know what I'm saying? This is, but when they get to us, no, no. You had our black brothers and sisters on white radio stations. If you didn't pay, it was no way in hell some of these records would have got broke. Sure. But they failed to realize that. Well, money is power.
It takes a lot of money to break a record nowadays.
Money is power.
It takes a lot to get a record.
They say 200,000. 200,000 break radio. So do you think you feel like you really need with all these? Because right now, I'm saying we're breaking
a lot of
records off of influence.
And really with radio, a lot of people not even listening to like the regular radio no more. A lot of people got their telephones or thing they call it, got the Sirius XM or whatever, Spotify, YouTube, whatever music platform. A lot of people not even listening to the regular radio.
I'm watching motherfuckers pay like random motherfuckers, $20 on Facebook, shit. So you got like influencers. Motherfucker had like 100,000 followers. Say shit, give me $20, or I'll promote this and do that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So and it's about reaching going direct to the fans, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And that is easy for you to go just to whatever music site you want to and type in somebody and you listen to music there. You know, so you're no longer having to go to the stores and do all this and do all that.
So basically, now you basically got to go live in this shit.
Yeah, you got to go live.
And then play like that. And that's, I mean, there's no way to break records because, I mean, you know, you follow on the show like that, because that's where they grew up in.
Yeah.
This shit is right here.
Yeah.
So, like I said, I'm saying, you reach the masses, you're going to play it. So you think radio going to be extinct soon? You think it's all right?
I ain't going to say it's going to be extinct, but the radio ain't the radio like the world move coming up.
Yeah,
you know, the radio ain't the radio no more. You know, and it's good to get your music on the radio, but a lot of people not. Our generation, we still following the radio. We're still throwing some radio here and there. Yeah. But our the younger generation, what they call them, X, the little crazy motherfuckers. Yeah, but you know, they do everything as social media.
Right.
Everything is. So they can visually see, I'm going to type this in, I can go and do my workout, I ain't got to have no Walkman, you know, I ain't got to worry about my tape popping, now I ain't got to go buy me an anti-skip CD player. Remember then when you used to jog and your CD player just get to skipping and skipping,
yeah.
Or you're walking too fast, you know, so now everything is just straight through, but it's robbing the artist too.
True.
I look at it because the streaming is robbing the hell out of these artists. Because if somebody buy your single, when you coming up and you had the tapes or you had CDs, you were physically getting paid some money.
Right.
If somebody got a single for you, could sell it for $1. That dollar will come into you.
Right.
But now with streaming, you're not even getting. You sell it for $1, you might not even get 15 cents off that dollar.
Right. You get anybody, might get
you know, so everybody that got there and downloaded your music and
listening for free.
Right. The labels are got there recouping because they selling all the ads.
Right.
You know, they got there and got all these people coming in. We're going to pay you this for this amount of time to put it on different videos and different songs. You know, do a little break in between. And if you need this, if you need that, call such and such. You know.
So what do you think? Do you think artists right now, where the game is now, you think artists still need to be looking to get signed or keep it independent?
To be honest, I always say artists need, if you don't have a big following in the beginning, go to a label. Do you a one or two album deal. The label will put all the work behind you. Once you start getting your numbers up and your fan base up, after that second one, you can leave the label and go independent because you got your fan base. But the label did everything that needed to be done. They got everywhere with the promotional packages and sending it you all the way in South Dakota, straight out of North Carolina. Right. Ain't never been to South Dakota, but your music in South Dakota.
True.
You can go and do a show in South Dakota because that major that was behind you pushed you because they want to make some money. They want to recoup their money.
You already know.
So they're going to make sure they promote you properly.
Yeah.
You know, so I say do a one or two album deal, and then once you get there, fuck the majors. You know, and then go independent.
But that you nailed it. That's all people need to know, because everything is independent is the way to go. I'm gonna break it down another way. You know how many big people that's been doing radio all their life, now they got podcasts. They keeping now, like Angie Martinez, biggest radio personality in New York. She still has her show on radio, but now Revolt gave her a podcast deal. So she living the best of both worlds, because now I could book you to come on my radio show. Because you got to be booked through radio station.
Right.
Let the radio station book the artist to come on a radio show, right?
Right.
Now, once you get there, we got a good repertoire and a good understanding, right?
Right.
We people. Now, I'm going to book you to come on my podcast. I get two for them paying for one.
Right. Yeah, that's it, right?
Two monies.
So like Faye said, in the beginning, you need a machine.
I look at a lot of artists and they say they don't need no team and they just need just them and one other person. You can't do that, not these days, because you need somebody to be able to film you while you record. You can't film your damn self.
Mm-hmm.
What are you going to do, put the phone up or your camera up and say, okay, I'm going to sit right here and I'm going to perform from here. But then they can't see the fans. They can't see nobody interacting. So you got to have your cameraman.
Definitely.
So, you know, you want to have a DJ if you're doing like live sets, because DJ going to get everybody crunk.
Right.
Once you get to a certain spot, you want to be a publicist, because some of y'all can rap, but some of y'all can't talk worth a damn.
Don't know what to say.
Don't know how to articulate your words. You cover the hood. You stay talking hood. So once you start getting a certain spot, you need to get a publicist. You know, and before you start signing these contracts, get you a goddamn lawyer. An entertainment lawyer, not a hood lawyer that got their
paralegal.
Yeah, or a paralegal, get you an entertainment lawyer. It's going to cost you a little change, but you know, if you really want to get in this game, man, you got to make sure you got all your I's dotted and your T's crossed.
Right, better than I've been.
You know, because, you know, I always tell people it's an entertainment business, and a lot of folks remember entertainment if we get the business part.
All right.
Of course.
So let me ask you another question, on a side note. How did that show come in? Let's talk about y'all show, man. What's up with y'all, with the Party Punisher? What's going on?
Which one? The Party Punisher TV show? The Party Punisher radio show?
That's what I'm saying.
The Pussy Punisher show? You know, which one?
Oh, I think I'm a shower cat too. Appreciate it.
Oh, yeah. You know, and we get ready to bring them.
I guess I'm a shower cat.
We get ready to bring those back.
Hey, I got my cap. Fuck
yeah, we get ready to bring back.
You got your cap.
I got my cap.
Yeah,
we got
bring
cap. But I'm glad you asked that. I'm glad Fitz broke it down like that. We got three shows, actually.
Right,
we got the Party Punisher TV show.
Okay.
We got the Party Punisher radio show.
Okay.
And we still do the Pussy Punisher show. You know, we do that. Matter of fact, our last guest was incredible. I'm going to just clap for that. Our last guest was incredible. I love her so much.
When my last guest was? Yeah, you left some good mark, goddamn it.
Hey. But all of those are going good. I mean, you know, the Party Punisher TV show, radio show, those are through Connected, Entertainment and Wellness
Center.
KG, my man, holding us down. The Pussy Punisher, that's through Visuals by Face.
All right.
That's through Visuals by Face. They're all going great, because we just had Goddess on our TV show and radio show. And for a young lady that's 5 years old, she is better than some grown adults that has been on our show.
Yeah. That's why I sit up and say the publicist.
Yeah.
When I say Muscle and Miss Bay Ford got her right, they got her right.
That's what's up. Shout out to Muscle and Miss Bay Ford, man. What's that?
Well,
for real.
Well, yeah, you got to, man. You got to have somebody to help you talk, because some of you jokes don't know how to talk, and they're talking their way out of a deal.
Yeah.
They'll talk their way out of a deal because they say, well, they're entertainment, they can rap, they got some nice lyrics, but they joke as dumb as a box of rock. So, you know, sometimes.
Shit, they might be running sound just because of that fucking reason.
Yeah, so, you know, sometimes you just got to make sure you got the right team, though.
You got the machine.
And also, because I heard you talking about the three shows, we're getting ready to start filming probably next month, waiting on some more donations to come through from the church folk. You know, but we're getting ready to start shooting our salvation.
What's that about?
Oh, that's the church.
That's the church.
We, as long as you come.
Okay.
We just want them to come.
All right. See.
And then come again. You know, it's
on the corner where?
69 and Conolingus Avenue. Right. So we just need them to come. That's all.
What kind of church? What's the religion?
Salvations. That's the religion.
Okay.
As long as they salivate,
we speak on coming.
Yeah, the power of the tongue. The power of the tongue.
But that?
We didn't say that.
We didn't say that. We just said come. Now you said buzzing.
You said that.
He didn't talk about buzzing that.
Yeah, yeah,
talking
about the power of the tongue.
I didn't buzz it.
The power. We didn't say that. You said it's salvation.
It's a salvation.
That's running into too long.
That's running face to see.
And you remember?
And I'm
sweeping the fuck out of
here. I'm the best. I'm the
best. Yeah, I know some man. What's on the back of the box?
It's nothing. We just want you to come.
Just come.
Y'all need to make you guys.
You have to watch the first episode to see.
Yeah,
but that's
you have to watch the first episode.
Man, I'm way too goddamn. I remember this. No, ain't no fucking way. I'm way too goddamn.
I'm dead serious.
Salvation, my motherfucking ass.
Yeah, salivating, salivating. All right, it's coming soon, man.
AKA Scarsy, goddamn. Y'all ain't fooling me, goddamn. Shit, y'all ain't church. Tabernacle now. I know what goddamn. Y'all ain't fooling me, goddamn. I was born tonight, that last night.
We, man,
I'm talking to the OG phase, nigga, little son. Y'all got to keep fucked up. Like, who the fuck up? And man, they're not just about that for real.
The name of the show.
That nigga's stupid.
It's called Celebrating
Salvation. So, y'all get ready to be
Celebrating Salvation.
Yeah, and Celebrating Salvation.
Put it in your SS and watch what happens.
Yeah, Celebrating Salvation is on the
board.
69 Cummins. And Conolingus
Avenue. Yeah, that's right. Do you need the address, man?
Yeah, 69 Commons and Conolingus Avenue. That's the address for Celebrating Salvations.
Y'all are fucking crazy, man.
Hey, fucking crazy.
But y'all are the chain, man.
It's our new show.
Yes, Celebrating Salvations.
Hey, y'all heard anything, but somebody will get pregnant.
So we're going to be looking for some parishioners.
I got the cookie on the car.
We just need parishioners to come. Just come. Come as you are. Just come.
Hey, well, y'all ain't gonna win with these niggas here, man. There's no way out, man.
I mean, that's all, man. We are
y'all
here. We are here to make a better community.
That's all.
We want everybody to be happy.
This is what happened on Back in the Church. See how they these niggas here, man.
And as long as you come, you'll be happy. You know.
Man, this ain't come be happy.
Yeah, come be happy.
Preach.
But just come.
Just come.
That's the main thing, you know.
These ain't paid too much.
Now hold up. Let's get back on this topic before he go cuckoo over here.
Y'all know what's crazy.
I like to enlighten people too.
Niggas too, man.
See, a lot of people talk about, you know, Jay-Z. Jay-Z is the number one businessman in hip hop right now.
Y'all call him crazy.
You got the baby.
He got good, got dirty.
Oh, come on, yeah, okay.
Yeah, number one in hip hop when it comes to business. Y'all can call that man crazy.
Yeah, I ain't gonna debate with that. But where I was going with was a lot of people think that he just did it. Like when Rockefeller came on. Like that was it. No. People don't understand. Like labels, even before he went independent, he was signed to that label with Jazzo. They had a song called Hawaiian Soldier. Mm-hmm. Then, before Jazzo, people don't know that Jay-Z was signed with Cold Chillin' because he used to open up for Big Daddy Kane. So he went through the machine. He knew what it took to move the machine.
So once he figured it out,
Once he figured it out, and he got with some cats that knew what to do, and they took the game like Faye said, they hustled themselves. Then you let suffer the product.
You better.
And then look at Rockefeller. But the thing with Rockefeller was, sometimes you let the wrong people into your circle. Because see, Dane was the type to open up the door when everybody come in. You can't let everybody in. You can't let everybody in. That's just like me. It be certain cats, I'm like, you that dude fire. Let me face it over. Just something about him that rubbed me wrong way, so nah, you can't be no puncher.
Definitely understand that. About the energy, man.
Yeah, shit, no disrespect. I love all y'all. But I said on TV, some of you damn punishers need to go.
Hold on, man.
This is a joke for a moment.
Hold on. I need my sound effect for that motherfucker. Hold on, man.
You know, I'm gonna make you laugh. You know how, say, I'm that's my brother, right?
All right.
That's my brother. And you know, I'm gonna say I'm the father, that's the uncle of the punisher, right? You know how you be sitting there talking to your brother and you be looking at your kids?
Yeah.
This motherfucker just ain't.
Yeah, some of them manage his head.
Some of them manage for no fucking reason.
Yeah,
just manage.
Just do dumb shit and you go. But I don't get mad because I used to be one of them that used to do. I used to do dumb shit. So you gotta take that into consideration. You can never crucify somebody for you used to do some of the same shit, but all you do is go, damn, I used to do dumb shit like that.
Right.
But yeah, some of them punishes this.
What's up with the coalition thing? What are they doing anything? Because I know y'all run DJs and shit like that, man. What's up with all the coalitions we have DJs, man? I'm trying to figure out, man, we got a lot of coalitions, a lot of groups and shit in the Carolina, man, but I'm trying to see where the movement is.
If you're talking about the coalition DJs, I rock with them. The coalition DJs are my people.
And they still doing the press box right on Sundays, right?
No, that's not the coalition.
I'm saying Mike Scott still doing it, right?
Yeah, that's Mike Scott.
Shout out to Mike Scott, man.
Yeah, shout out Mike Scott. Mike Scott, my man. Actually, Mike Scott be DJing
You ready to join?
At the 49th anniversary.
Let's talk about that while we on that. I see you got another man. Who are you got showing up, man?
Ooh, man, you got me on. I got
Well, you maybe ain't trying to forget nobody, but we just got down, man, some Carolina shit, man.
Yeah. I got
Hey, you remember that, baby?
Because the door just opened up. Like,
oh. What you need, man?
Are y'all lying?
Yeah. You good? We just magazine
traffic? Which is a hooker, a small hooker.
Show me which one I'm talking about, because I got a couple small ones, one of those small ones. And a little clip, the white box.
Yeah, and then there's one in the front boxes, a little bigger, and then there's a little light.
The little white one is 25, the other one is 30. You ain't telling the big boxes, you're telling the small ones.
Itty bitty ones, it's like probably like 10, 15, something
like that. Oh, the real small one is 25. The other one in the little blue box is 30.
See, we back in traffic live on air. We don't play no game. We get this out.
Yeah,
we get it out. It's not odd. We got DJ Darth Vader. DJ Darth Vader. He's 53 years old. We got
DJ Black.
We got DJ Black, 54 years old, out of High Point. Crazy. The energy is gonna knock you off your feet. Matter of fact, I'm gonna hit you with a bang. DJ Black is Taliban for Money Moves Follow.
Straight up. Hey, that's what's up.
The energy that Taliban got on the mic, his father got on the ones and twos.
Hey, shout out to Taliban, my nigga.
A lot of folks don't know about Taliban. Neither Taliban started as a DJ.
He started as a DJ.
I didn't even know that.
Yeah, Taliban was a DJ at first before he started.
Taliban, you tell me that, man.
Yeah, Taliban was a DJ.
We got DJ. We got DJ T.O.P.
He's coming.
So we got my partner who I started
the party with. You know, T.O.P. made that moonshine beat.
I heard.
T.O.P.
My father told me. Who started the Party Punishers with me? Ecstatic DJ Q Mix.
Oh man, Q Mix was bad.
Q Mix.
Q Mix on those nigga cons too, man. Boy,
yeah,
man,
go, man, right? Man.
He been killing the shit.
And he paid that big dog over there. I think on the way was in Chicago somewhere. Hey man, love you, Q Mix, man. You my dog, man.
My man. This is how you know you old school. DJ Rexki.
Rexki with the name Rexki.
Rexki,
you know that's old school.
Rexki. I said we got DJ Mike Scott. We got DJ Supreme from out of Gastonia.
That's what
You gonna remember I'm old school. We bringing DJ Facade back.
Oh, come on, that's my dog, man.
Facade gonna be there.
Facade, what's happening? Yeah.
Let me get over here. Let me get.
It's gonna be. It's gonna be a dope event, man. It's gonna be dope, man.
If y'all haven't been out to Connected Center yet, man, go out there and check it out, man. It's dope.
We got DJ LeBron gonna be there.
And LeBron's a beast.
That would do it.
We got
DJ. And his daughter, she's a heck of an entertainer as well.
Right, she's sick.
Yeah.
Rexki. Performing. Your boy coming back out. My son, Dun Dada.
Dun Dada, what's happening? Stop, man. Tell us to get in the studio, man. Stop playing, man. And my dog.
Who else we got?
Got OG Pook.
OG Pook.
Shout out, Pook. Pook, what's up, man? Tell you stop playing. Let's go to work, man. Stop playing, Pook.
You know we got yourself. Love Bone will be hitting the stage.
You know we there talking
about. We got the youngest in charge. She gonna be hitting the stage.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Goddess.
Yeah.
We got Silky Jones in the
city. Man, OG Silk was hanging.
OG, one of the first ones in the city.
Hey, Space Big, we were talking about you the other day.
Silk. One of the
first. Hey, we got Space Big and bigger, man. Space Big, he been talking about you the other day, man. He talked good. How do you, Silk? My motherfucking dog, man. Shout out to Space Big the other day.
Yeah, and then we got something that's just going to make me feel so good. We got Cut Lord Swift. That's B.O.D. DJ.
Man, that's what's up, man.
And we got, I'm going to show you how we digging. We got Gabby the Gift that used to be on the Dave Chappelle show.
That's what's up, man. Hey, if y'all want to come to this event, man, August 13th. Man, tell me about the event, man. What's going on?
August 13th, man, it's going down big. The Connected Entertainment and Wellness Center. Live out there in Salisbury, North Carolina. With Sound Enlightened by my man Tone. If you ever, ever been to a concert and had this type of sound, it's incredible. It's the Party Punishers and the Connected. We giving 49 year anniversary of hip hop. We got DJs, MCs, graffiti artists, break dancers, and beatboxers. It's gonna be incredible. And if you want an event, reach out to Kevin Glover. Reach out to Kevin Glover. And man, we're gonna have a great time. Doors open at 5, show starts at 5:45.
And ain't nobody killing y'all on the bidding fees neither.
No.
You ain't gonna have to pay no hank, no 75, all of that. You get you a nice little.
Go ahead, Tom.
Go ahead, because I'm gonna be there. Magic Traffic and the Shades Line gonna be there. So y'all already know what time it is.
So we ain't killing nobody on the vendor price.
And the plenty space. I'm gonna tell you that, I done did. Plenty space out there too. Set it where you want to sit, man, it's dope.
It's dope.
It's dope, man.
It's going down.
Stage straight. Your height straight. It's wide enough, man. It's wide enough for you to perform and do what the fuck you do. If you have fun on that stage, you're fucking up. It's your fault.
Exactly.
You have fun on the stage, you're fucking up. That's your fault.
That's your fault.
Stage down there.
The stage is there.
Yeah. Hell of a stage.
The stage is there. The sound is there. Everything. I can tell you from the eye to the mouth. I just did.
And the sun ain't going to kill you.
No. But bring your own chairs.
Yeah,
bring your own chairs.
Bring your own chairs.
And if you want to interview on the Mackin Trick Podcast, you better holler at me, shoot me a DM. It's going down. The Shade Design will be there. For real. Shit. What is going on? What you got cracking? I know you're saying all types of
man,
shit.
Man, you know, August 27th, I've been in talks with in Libyan.
What's that?
They were the housing authority in Libyan. Is over housing authority now. So I had a meeting with them yesterday, putting this back to school drive together and just making sure we can use some of their properties, you know, where the apartments are, just to make sure we got our everything proper, you know, so we'll be able to do the back to school drives at some of those locations.
Oh, that's hey, back to school. Hey, man, we got a box over here to Shade Design, too, man. So y'all want to donate?
Yeah, so that's.
Give me a DM, man. Come donate, man. Back to school shit.
We do a one in August 27th. It'll be from 1 to 4 at, in Cedar Knoll Apartments, right up the road.
Southside.
Right up, yeah, Southside. S4.
All right.
You know, it's always 4-way or nowhere. You
know. Real.
You can't say Sam O'Fo without the folk. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about in the real folk. But I ain't going to get in all that.
But it's just big by that thing.
I ain't gonna get into all that though. But
hey, man. Y'all need to get together, man. Pick up this phone, man.
Yeah, but.
Shout out to my Flat Nose, too, man.
Yeah, me and Flat, I tell you, me and him started the 4-way or no way. That's my dog down and dirty. Okay. But, yeah. But.
That's how I ain't been in the 4. I told you I've been out here, Bobby.
Yeah, but, we're gonna be doing that the 27th of this month.
Okay.
And it's gonna be from 1 to 4 p.m. Myself, my son's mother, who he was deceased, he died 2 years ago. But we have she started an organization called Jay's Big Give Back in his remembrance. So
okay.
Me and her teaming up this year to do a big book bag drive, because usually I do it, you know, myself, this will be my 8th year doing it. Right. You know, even during the pandemic, I was rocking it. But this year, we can't do it in my old community where I grew up at Winston Trails. You know, because his other folks about to settle. I ain't gonna say what ethnicity, but some other people about to settle, so we can't no longer use the center for the book bag donation. So
okay.
I wanted to keep it on the south side, so I reached out. You know, we reached out to Cedar Knoll Apartment. So
that's what's happening.
We'll be there August 27th from 1 to 4, you know, giving stuff out to the kids and then having a you know, have some food out there. You know, I'm gonna mess a grill up.
All right.
You know, and have a couple performances from some of the children artists, you know, and just allow them to have a good time. They last big shindig before they go back to school. See, I'm country, because you ain't heard shindig in a minute, have
you? Yeah, I know.
Yeah, so they can have they last.
Let me ask you a question. I've been watching the news lately, man. This shit crazy. And what's up with this monkeypox shit, man?
Man, I don't know. Shit. I had chicken pox, so I'm like, I can get monkey pox.
Man, that's
I had chicken pox.
Like state emergency, you know, all kind of shit.
Yeah, in New York.
In the country, it's state of emergency.
It's state of emergency. The monkey pox. But this, it has so many people put out there so many different meanings of what monkey pox is. You don't even know what to believe.
You don't know what monkey pox is, but I think it's just goddamn chicken pox coming back around. Because I look at the monkey pox, chicken pox didn't get that big, but I remember being broke all out on your face and in your head, and you know.
I mean, chicken pox. All they just see is on the black
people. I don't know.
I'm turning the wrong channel. What the fuck I'm looking at? But every time I turn it, they was showing a black face, but they got
the with the monkey pox, so I don't know.
And they're trying to be funny.
They make me mad.
That's what I'm saying. They ain't calling monkey pox that.
Yeah, I'm calling it monkey pox. I don't even want a joke of eating a banana around me right now. I don't even want a joke of eating a banana around me right now. Because I'm going to get nerves.
Yo!
Man, you crazy as hell.
Eating a banana around.
Mm-mm.
Yo, you said you don't want a joke of eating a banana.
So what y'all think? So y'all think Kobe gone?
No, yeah. COVID ain't went nowhere.
I think they gonna shut down by November, man.
Nah,
ain't gonna shut down. They not as business smart to do it without Trump. See, Trump, even though Trump was giving out money, he knew what the back end was gonna bring back.
Right.
Yeah. Look at it now. Me and Faith was just driving yesterday. Was it yesterday or the day before yesterday? They paid you $20 an hour there with McDonald's.
Yeah, we was down over there. Concord.
$20 an hour.
They paid $20 an hour there. at Mickey D's, at Mick Negro's.
That's the name of that shit went up.
That was in Chicago.
Yesterday.
That was yesterday.
Wednesday. Shit.
Yesterday, because that night was in the Mall of the Girl yesterday.
$20 an hour.
Hey, well, Ronald McDonald ain't bullshit. Them shoes getting big and big and real.
Oh, I remember I saw that McDonald's. We would make a fast and the fast.
When I did it, it was $8. No, $8. It was $7 something.
Fast and the fast. That's $20. It's big. What you call that shit? The marquee.
Yeah.
$20 an hour.
Yeah, they $20 down the top cool. I say,
hey, somebody better go holler at the art.
Yeah.
Give me some big red shoes.
Hello, may I take your order?
For real. Do you want eggs and cheese on them? Hey, now you're going to read the plate with the goddamn sauce. Give me my goddamn sweet sour sauce, man.
Yep. And fix them damn ice cream machines.
Yeah.
Fix that motherfucker.
Okay, another thing is, mother always asking what we got going on. So, you know, we got the Party Punisher TV show, Party Punisher radio show, we got the Pussy Punisher show, we got the Salvation's show getting ready to come up. We got Visuals by Face, we got the gentleman and the Gangster production getting ready to come out, and we got Face's Kitchen that we get ready to start recording that, and we also get ready to come out with all natural wine, you know. I used to bang out real hard with the shea butters and mango butters and all. So we're gonna get back into that, bring all natural back. But when our babies will be rebirthed, and Face and myself have a blessing, even with our big brother with Alexa will be opened up this month, August.
What was the name of it now?
Elixir.
Okay.
Yeah, Elixir grown up. We'll be opening back up. We'll be opening back up this month. So once we open up, we're doing a soft opening at first, and then we're gonna reopen all the way. The food's gonna be marvelous.
All right.
Because it's gonna be a four-star chef in the kitchen. You know,
can I get my special drink, man? Can I create something in? Put it up.
We'll.
I know how you do. Right, that's why I said it, bro. I know how you do, big.
So we'll see.
Stay with the drink.
Elixir Lounge.
For real.
Elixir Lounge will be.
That's what's up, man. That's what most of us had, man. That's what's up.
Yeah, we're going to have a four-star chef in the kitchen, man. So
that's what we do, man.
Big boom!
Oh, I know what I meant to tell you. Video shoot Saturday. Cadillac Slim Lounge, man. Tequila shots. 7 p.m.
I got to go to Slim Lounge, man. I seen him the other night. Cadillac, if you're looking for, I got to come out there.
Yeah.
But we'll come out there after, because we work inside
there. Brand don't never stop.
Don't never fucking stop. Also, the short films on YouTube, man. Shout out to Chase Boy TV, man. All or Nothing and Better Than Beast, man. Y'all go check them shits out on YouTube too, man. Short film doing numbers on the short film, man. Shout out to Chase Boy TV.
Which one is that when you the pet?
Oh, that's a Better Than Beast.
I love that joint.
Yeah, that's a Better Than
Beast.
And if y'all check it out,
you say other one is All or Nothing.
All or Nothing. That one I'm playing pocket check and me and Break Break.
And go on Tubi, man, because we're doing a lot of stuff down here at the CAC, man.
And shout out to Marcus Madsen, man.
Yeah,
Tubi, man.
Go to Tubi.
The Last Days of
Black Rob, man. Yeah, man. Go to Tubi.
Hello, G Madsen.
Go watch that, man.
Yeah.
Shout out to Marcus.
There you
go. Muscle, everybody on.
Yes, sir.
You know, and then go check out, since we're talking about movies, go check out that God City.
Oh, for real. And it's still on Amazon.
Yeah, it's on Amazon Prime, on Tubi. You know, go check out that God City, man. And everybody want to say why we got our city, because the G the seventh letter, the O, and then the D is the fourth letter. We ain't nothing but God. You know what I'm talking about?
Big was talking about it the other day.
You know, so the God city, man.
That's what I tell everybody. You got the G, which is the seventh letter, the O, which is the 15th letter, and the D, which is the fourth. You understand what I'm saying? So you take 7 and 15 is what?
22.
22 and 4 is what?
26.
2 and 6 is what?
8.
Okay. 704. When you break all that down, it goes all the way back to the 8, because 704 builds and destroys everything is either elevation or deterioration, depending on yourself.
If you turn it sideways, isn't that offending?
Always. See, there's many ways to break down knowledge. Yep.
That we call knocking the traffic makes you never know where you're going to learn something from.
There's always many ways to break down knowledge. I'm loving this mountain nigga, though, what you see, please.
Yeah, my
yeah, it's that mountain nigga.
That's what we do, man. See, this is what's going on Mackin Traffic, man. We don't need to talk about the hip-hop, man. We educate, man, and we do a lot of stuff on Mackin Traffic, man. This shit is that's what we call it Mackin Traffic. You never know who you're going to see in front of this motherfucking camera. You know what I'm talking about?
Man, you had Big Boy, man. Big Boy, man.
I got to say this right quick.
Happy birthday, Big Sir 50, man.
Yeah, but somebody had set up and said Trump was trying to bankrupt the economy. He didn't try to bankrupt the economy. It wasn't on him. Y'all gonna leave Trump alone. If Trump was home, I bet that girl wouldn't be over there in Russia.
That's bullshit.
Some goddamn smoke.
Free Britney. No fucking smoke, a fucking pen, man.
Yeah, pen. That's what I'm saying. For some smoke.
Come on, man.
You know, that's crazy. 9 years.
That's some bullshit,
so,
man.
So, all y'all wanting to go outside of America and go here
that's
and go
bullshit.
There.
Free Britney,
and,
man.
And talk shit about this country. We got a lot of shit that goes on here.
Yeah.
But we ain't getting no 9 years for no goddamn vape in here.
Hell, man.
I tell you that goddamn much.
Man, you got that shit right
you
there.
You know, our country doesn't treat us properly, us lower income folk, but I don't want to go no damn way else.
Let me tell you that much. People talk on that talk. I don't give a damn how big I get. I'm not leaving here. Like Lil Wayne said, I'm not going nowhere. You know that dude? That man kept away. He liked to smoke. He liked to do different.
They want to catch you.
And then if they found out you got a name, we really going to have a ball with you.
Because they weren't going to release her. They were going to release her back here, but we might have to get them an arms dealer. And America didn't want a bad one going for that. I say, I need to know what's going on with Biden. This joker getting the railroad too damn much. Every time you turn around, he got COVID.
I don't know, but I seen the photo that got in the bicycle.
Then he followed off a stationary bicycle that ain't even damn moving. You gotta keep man, what's really going on?
And why they keep hiding Kamala, man? When the fuck she come out every day, once every 6 months?
Who?
Kamala, Ms. Harris.
Who?
Oh, my bad.
Oh.
My Jones, dude.
Oh, okay. is it Kamala or Kamala?
I don't fucking know.
I don't know what the hell.
Kamala, Kamala, either one I don't deal
with. The woman that married
him.
The woman married to the white man.
Yeah, whatever her name is, because she wasn't African-American.
Oh, I know what was fucked up, though. What about the wife of the motherfucking Supreme Court judge? The the wife that's doing the business, doing the dirty shit. Supreme Court judge, only black, the only black, I think.
Who Clarence?
Clarence Thomas. Yeah, what's up with that shit, man?
Yeah, Clarence Thomas, and you can't say black man, because Clarence ain't never been black. I don't know.
Man.
I think Clarence, you remember that Chappelle skit?
Yeah.
When Chappelle was the Klan.
Yeah.
He couldn't see. That what was his name? Dixby?
Yeah.
That's Clarence Thomas. That's Clarence Thomas.
Well, yeah.
He's Dixby.
All right, before I put another question for y'all, because I see y'all travel, man. What's up with, how y'all feel about what's going on right now with Carolina as far as the underground scene, the music scene, the support system, the ecosystem right now as far as the entertainment? How y'all feel about it? What's going on right now? Are we growing or we just going to...
We growing a little bit, but everybody has to start supporting each other, man. Because I can look at, you can put a Carolina showcase together. Not no major artist. I ain't going to say no one who's made it to the A's level or B level. But you put some C and down artists together, you ain't going to get that many people in the house. But if we all support each other, you can start making them numbers. And once promoters start seeing you can pack the house, but that takes all the artists to get together, to work together. Let's start filling this little venue up. They got to be big venues, and you got 100 seater. And promoters start seeing you can fill that up. They're going to start coming to holler at y'all. But artists need to realize everybody got to work together, man. Everybody want to be the first. Sometimes it's good to sit in the back.
All right.
You know, and then come forward, man. But we got a good little thing going on in the city, man, and in the state.
Yeah.
Both states, both Carolinas. You know, but we just got to all work together and cut all the BS out, man. That's really what's messing our growth up.
Stop the violence, man.
Yeah, once you start getting out the street, and I never understood it, you start getting out the street and you making good money, what the hell you going back in the damn street for? That's backwards as hell.
I'm talking about the hustle to get out the street.
Yeah, hustle to get out the street. That's as dumb as the ones from Ballantyne want to come to the hood. Y'all retarded too.
We kind of get to Ballantyne.
Yeah.
Kind of own some shit.
You know, so, you just, the music scene down here good though, man. We got some nice artists coming from down here, man. We just need our city to support.
All right.
Need our states to support them, man. That's really about it.
Well, I'm. That's what I'm gonna say about it.
Say what you gotta say. We're Mackin' the Trap.
Tell them why you're mad, Zach. Yeah, I'm gonna sit up and say this.
Say that shit, man. Say it with your chest.
We got a lot of great talent just in the city, right?
Yeah.
We ain't gonna go outside the city. But the talent that we have is the same cats that'll shake your hand, but when they walk away from you, they got something to say about you.
You walk away, they stab in your damn face.
My thing is, now, you a great business person. Great. I've been with you long, not everybody. Great business person, and you're one hell of an artist. My thing is, if you was to say, I'm going to say this, what would make us grow is people, let me say this, I take a Prince song, boom. I want to start going to DJ. Let's just try to listen to my team first. Get a Prince song. Get a Luck Bone. Get a Face to do visuals and go ahead to talk to some of these clubs. Get a Jay Breezy. I got my Luck Bone, I got my Jay Breezy. I got Prince Saab. He gonna do the event. Give me a Bigger Boo, I got me a host. Give me a Shadeezy. I got my Shadeezy right here. Give me... He doing his own thing, I don't know about him. Give me, I got Jay Breezy, Shadeezy. I got Luck Bone. Give me Black Bart. Give me Black Bart. Create your own chicken circuit. Create your own chicken circuit. That we can go from Charlotte to Myrtle Beach, just in different towns, and different, however you want to do it. And it's all ours. Because we all independent. We all independent. We put up the bread, Face, go talk to them. Boom, 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 boom. You make all the visuals. You got cameras. What got cameras? We got everything. We got sound. Some of the places we'll go to have sound. Now that's how you create and grow. Now you create your own tour.
You put it together. I'm with
you. But you gotta put a tour together of everybody that's cool and don't mind. Because with a tour, it goes with what it said. Even though we on tour, everybody got their own entourage. So the shit is gonna be like, boom. When we get to the place, the venue, all we gotta do is pay for security.
Yeah, we all damn secure.
Nah, I'm gonna keep my business to that people.
Yeah,
you show people that you some hood jokers that can do this. Guess what? Like you said, now promoter gonna wanna get in and put us on a bigger platform. We just doing the chipper circuit.
And shout out to Pete Frank too, man.
That's why we're going to Pete Frank.
Yeah. Ooh. Pete Frank is a beast, man. Y'all don't know who Pete Frank is. You're slipping, man. Pete Frank is.
Shout out to Pete Frank, man.
You ain't going to see. You ain't going to hear nobody sound like Frank. Frank is Frank. Pete Frank is Pete Frank, man. So y'all go check him out, man, on YouTube. He just dropped some new stuff. We got a lot of.
We got an idea, man. Let's put this shit together and we'll make something work. What y'all want to talk about, man, say before we get up out of here, man? Or we Mackin' the Trap for y'all, know y'all boys, we got busy shit going on.
Free the steps, man. Step gang. Free all them boys, man. Yep, they're free everybody. Free my brothers. Anybody that's incarcerated should be incarcerated. Free y'all. Now, y'all rapists and booty bandits, y'all still be dead. But everybody else, you know, free the ones that need to be free.
All right.
Oh, but that's
keep the rapists and the snitches where they're supposed to be.
With that being said, man, shout out to all my party punishers. Love y'all, even though I'm pop y'all. My joint, my Ace Boom Coon, DJ Fight, what's happening, baby? What's happening, baby? You gotta come outside and play, baby.
Fight will be there too on the 13th.
Yeah, Fight will be there on the 13th, showing out. Do dirty.
I know you got a free bottle, man.
Do dirty in love.
Ain't wrong with that.
And to my homie, Gorgeous Jersey. You know how we do.
Jersey, what's happening?
Nicky the Key, Big Hoss.
Nicky, what's up?
You already know. But Donald B, Mad Flash.
Hey, you know he's better. He just got my friend pulled up.
Who?
Donald always gonna be.
He got to have the exclusives on his feet.
Shout out to Kevin Glover, man. Keep grinding.
Oh, Kevin Glover, you know I was getting to that. We all was getting to that. Oh, and also, remember, man, when you were the Party Punishers, stay connected. We backing and we trapped.
Y'all go to the YouTube pages, check them out. Party Punisher YouTube page. Go to the Step and Jit page. Go run his numbers up. 3 months, he already over 5,000 views. With no promotion, y'all go check some of that stuff out too, man. And don't forget to go check the movie out, God City, man. Go check that out, man.
A whole lot of bullshit, man. Hey, look, we Mackin in traffic, man. I appreciate my brothers coming through, man, and giving me some of their time throughout the day on this lovely Friday, man. August 13th, 49th anniversary, hip-hop. Connected well, son. Pull up, it's going down, man. Y'all already know the gate info. The event spot, how that is, man, is going down, man. Reach out to the OG. Prince I. Stay connected, man. Mackin in traffic. The Shade Designer, we in this motherfucker, man. We're going to holler at y'all in a minute, man. Stay focused. Subscribe to the YouTube channel, Mackin in traffic. Love on podcast. Hey, man, the Shade Designer open every day, man. We ship. We send, and we got the best price here. We take EBT. So how that is, man. It's going down like that. Whole lot of bullshit. M time down, game time entertainment. We out this bitch. For real. Huh? Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Miss Speedball. That was a good one.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Anybody want to donate before I end this live? Anybody want to donate for the back to school drive? Y'all can contact me or Kashana Sanders, which is my son's mother. Either one of us, we got asking for financial donations. If you can purchase the stuff yourself.
I'm talking in old bitch. We ain't playing with this shit. My reason stay in the kitchen. All he know is that word. Yeah, he stay with their pie. All he know is skirt. No, he just start trying to the clock. He really know what it's about. He get it and get it out. Until he find his way out. My reason stay in the kitchen. All he know is that word. He say he stay with their pie. All he know is skirt. No, he just start trying to the clock. He really know what it's about. He get it and get it out. Until he find his way out.
What's that? What's that? Anybody call me? Is that
my shirt? No, we're gonna make some shit work.
So you're
gonna make some shit work.
Hey, you already know what time it is. Don't pick it up.
Make some shit.
Hit that thing, my baby. And that's what
we're gonna do.
Hey, don't give a damn thing. You gotta do what you gotta do, bro.
Make it work. You got the Mackin and traffic in the back. Got side to the right, left of it.
All right.
So we can both be seen. Boom. There we go.
We're in the game.
I'm good. I said, boy, you only could imagine what the fuck looked like, Asher.
Oh, this shit, nigga. You started with y'all, nigga. I'll be talking that shit. We about to get in by the phone. We about to be over 49, nigga. You got to promote it.
Oh, yeah.
The Bluetooth device is ready to pal.
It's ready to pal. Let me from over there.
The Bluetooth device is connected successfully.
She from over there on the other side. Yeah.
Work them. China all day long, fair, you know. You know that's China. You know that's China.
You miss me. And you
everybody ready, cause I gotta hit record on them, record on them. One more. One more. I can see the middle. Let me know you're straight, but they ain't turning. If you see it straight, then. You good? You look straight?
Yeah, where can you see middle? I can't see that shit. Yeah, that's great. That's good, yeah. Yeah. Right there. Boom.
Good to go. Come on, got them. Come on, start poking.
I'm trying to get some more for the ringer off.
Come on, start Make sure I got every goddamn. I'm about to pull one of the face moves. You already know how I go. Get in there. Come on. Get in there. Bam.
That Joker utilizing everything.
Oh, sorry, you know it's not a game.
Yo, I know. I forgot a couple times. But I see he utilizing phone and iPad.
You know it's not a game. Yeah, no, we got them six camera shouted, man. We ain't playing no games. Yes, sir. We got action. Okay, so I'm at the mobile view. Because I need that shit. So what I'm going to have to do right there, make sure we still turn that. How are we looking over their face on that one?
Yeah, good.
You good right there?
Yeah.
Boom, okay. Get them back in action right here. Yeah. They start tripping.
You want this?
Yeah, I can drink it, please.
Y'all want some to drink?
I got water, thanks, sir. You got a Sprite back there?
Oh, no, I got check.
Oh, Mountain Nigga.
Might be a
Mountain Nigga in there.
Yeah, I'll take a Mountain Nigga.
Yeah, might be a Mountain Nigga in there. Appreciate it.
Yeah,
great nigga might be in now.
Yeah, I'll take a soda. Any kind of soda.
That's what I mean. I'm going to try to get you drunk. Yeah.
Okay, now we got action. There we go. And they're the main one right there. Let me get you right. Come on down a little bit. Bam. That motherfucker, they're a fool.
See, I like them little things, but them things too low. I have to be looking at the screen all home.
Just put the thing on the big screen. That's clear as day. Okay, boom, 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 boom. We in the game. That's it. That's all I got to do with the intro. We in the game, bro. You want to check out the buttons on this, right? All
right. Oh, Lord.
All right, that's the mic volume right here in the middle.
What?
Right here. The mic right in the front, right here in the middle, right here. All right. That's the volume. That's going to be the volume on the speaker. The first volume speaker right there on the right. If you want to hit the button, it's too low. I'm speaking right here. All right. On that, if you want to play with it.
You want me to hit it right quick just to see?
No, you got it. You play with the volume. I'm going to turn it up. So you're going to turn it.
I'm glad you got over there. I like when fish learn new shit.
That's why you want to do the first one, man. You want to turn it up or something. Whenever you feel like hitting whatever, I'm going to hit the intro. Now we're in the game. I'm going to end the inning for the bitch over two. Yeah, I don't know. We got that much paper. Let me get that much paper. That shit look quick, man. You got to get it right, buddy. In a minute, nigga, sit his ass down without them goddamn camera.
Nah, that's good marketing promotion.
Boy, you already know.
I tell motherfucker that that's the best thing.
Yeah, old mountain there.
Thank you so much, sis. Yeah.
Appreciate you, bro. You need something, you got?
Turn
that air.
Why is it
starting to get like that? I don't know. I'm about to get the fan again. You good? I got the front box. Alright. Cool, cool. All right, everybody, crank it up right now. Let me get this intro and go. For real? While they got them on live, just tuning in, doing whatever they do.
Welcome to the campus. Made us a plan.
Right now, man, Mackin and Trapper Podcast with your boy Love Bone, man. We still talking shit, swallow spit. You know how it already go, man. This ain't no rehearsal, nothing like this, man. We do this shit on the daily. You know what I'm talking about? That's what we call it, Mackin and Trapper. Right now, man, I got some special guests in here today, man. It's going down, man. So my player partners, homeboys, brothers, long time grind. Man, y'all already know what it is, man. It's going down like this. Y'all already know them from their own radio show. You know what I'm talking about? Party Punch Radio Show. You know what I'm talking about? DJing coast to coast with this shit. Promotion, man. This man hit all type of shit. I ain't getting any name to have for his list. You know what I'm talking about? My big dog got his anniversary coming up. Hope y'all lined up to perform, come do your thing, man. One time, man. 49 years of putting in work. You know what I'm talking about? It's going down, man. We making the traffic. I got the one and only DJ Prince side this motherfucker to my motherfucking left, man, as y'all can see. And I got the goddamn OG face on this side, man. Showing y'all how we do this shit, man. It's going down Mackin traffic style, man. What's happening, fella?
You already know. Before we get into it, let me break it down a little bit better. I appreciate that, and I hope to make it to 49 years.
My was it 39?
No. What it is this 1973, hip-hop was created.
Oh.
So August 11th in Sedgwick Ave Projects. August 11th. But we're celebrating the 49th anniversary of hip-hop.
Yes, sir.
Hip-hop has been around for 49 years, and this time that's been acknowledged to everybody. And we're bringing the DJs, we're bringing the MCs, we have beatboxers, we have graffiti artists, and we have break dancers that's gonna be out here with us as well as yourself in the stage.
Yes, sir.
And that's the honor and the pleasure the Party Punishers and Kevin Glover from Connected. We together and we gonna do this. What's popping up?
Man, you already know, man. Instead of talking shit for a spit, man. Hang out with Kevin and Fastlane, baby.
That's it.
No, what's up, man? Tell me who you is, man. Come on, man.
I know what it is, man. OG of the city, OG face guy, the AKA Ram face. You know, when I go to Salvation, because I'm your baby mama, your mama, and your grandmama's favorite pastor. Have mercy.
Hey, for real, man. So we going, man. We cool, man. We gonna get it in, man. So we 49 years of hip hop.
Right. Yep. 49 years.
So hip hop is young as shit, man. It's only 50 years.
Man, and what's crazy though? Hip hop then took over the world globally.
Globally, you can't sell cereal without hip hop.
You can't.
You can't sell oodles and noodles without hip hop.
You can't.
So how to say hip hop ain't the shit, man? This shit is crazy.
It started.
It's the youngest.
Yeah, you know what? It's crazy. The youngest genre of music, but it's took over
everything.
Everything. If you go to Asia, you got somebody doing some hip hop. You go to Africa, it's hip hop.
Yep.
You know, you go to any continent on the world, it's some hip hop influence somewhere.
And the crazy part about it is, with hip hop, you go all over the world, like Fitz said, all over the world. They don't understand English, but they can speak your song word for word.
And that's just fucking amazing, man. That's damn amazing.
And that's the power of hip hop, man. And they wanted to abolish hip hop and get rid of it. And look at it. Everybody was against it at first, you know, banned in the USA and all of that, you know, but now look.
Still taking, they're still trying to kill it. They can't stop it.
They can't stop what was intended to run the world.
Right.
You gotta think about it. Hip hop been in the White House.
Yep.
Damn, so did.
Hip hop been in the White House, Run DMC, Eazy-E. Yes, come on, all these cats performed, chilled, ate dinner with different, Snoop Dogg ate dinner with different presidents in the White House. This is hip hop.
Goddamn right.
I remember when my mother told me, boy, stop playing that mess. I don't want to hear that. So I would go outside, I'd get into trouble. But when she bought me my first turntables in 1979, I stayed in the house. She was content. And that's gonna make that boy stay in the house and stay out of trouble.
Yes.
Look how many people that hip hop saved their lives.
Yeah.
Hip hop has taken lives.
I mean, jobs are off the
MC. Right. Hip hop has taken lives, but it saved more lives. Okay. And like you said, look how many people was coming out of penitentiary, but their man's got on and was giving them jobs.
Giving them jobs.
Yep.
And they got to go through none of that bullshit and all that other shit. You just can't, you know what I'm saying? This is what you do, bro. You with me all day.
You with me. And my whole thing is, you good with math, with making the other product shit? Well, I'm product. Well, make me shit.
You make me shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it ain't nothing but a hustle.
Nothing but a hustle. And that's what you got to do, man. And shit. And so, we 49 years of hip-hop.
Right.
And Carolina still ain't got a good year in yet. Cause we ain't hit yet. We still ain't hit yet.
Nah, we ain't hit. Carolina ain't hit. We only got three mainstream artists really. Carolina. That's Moray. That's
Moray popping.
Yeah, Moray.
We got Moray J. Cole, baby.
That's it. That's really three.
White like that.
Yeah, Black Zach, he's starting to bubble a little bit down there in South CAC, but North CAC artists is only really three artists that's doing the on a major right now.
Mm-hmm. It's four. Mm-hmm. It's four, because if you think about
that's
it,
anything?
He in his own lane, De Niro Ferrar sold out a concert. I've seen it with my own eyes.
Yeah.
Bruno West by nine.
Yeah, with the Colt rap and all that, like that. That's that Tech N9ne type stuff. Like, Tech N9ne owns everything of his, and they be talking what they be talking about, that's their own thing, but they pack houses. They turn out good. The Niro Ferrar catalog and his videos is ridiculous.
Yeah, the Niro.
He fine.
Niro, man.
Yeah, but right now, you know, and shout out to S. Dub, too, because I just seen he got a new
shout
project.
Out to three.
Yeah, you ain't really from the floor.
Yeah, shout out to three, man.
Shout out to Dub.
Man. Now, you say Rhapsody?
Rhapsody, Raleigh.
She's
a beast.
Matter of fact, that's my Corday from South Carolina.
Who?
Corday from North Carolina, from here. From West Salem, I think.
Yeah, so we starting to bubble.
I mean, Carolina got some people knocking on the door now.
You know, Lil Jubelli with the freestyling, you know.
And we got what's his name? What's up with King Carter's son? With the Tootsie?
Tootsie.
Yeah, we getting there. We ain't got there, like we need to be there.
Yeah.
Yeah. We should have been there, but you know.
Yeah.
Yeah. Should have been there.
But God got his own timing.
That's why I tell people, everything happens for a reason.
Oh, yeah.
Everything happens when it's supposed to happen, not when you want it to happen.
You got that shit right. So 49 years, fellas. So you've been DJing shit.
I've been DJing since 1979. I got 43 years in.
Yeah, you're right. They had the bird, player.
I got 43 years in. I started.
That dope as a motherfucker, man.
Yeah, I started in a project called Riverview Towers, where I grew up at in Paterson, New Jersey. My first influence of hip hop was in a project that was right across the street called CCP Projects.
Yeah.
Like, one day, you know, you're outside at 10, 11 years old and you hear this music coming from outside. Oh, what's the big speakers? And you see a big crowd, so I went over there. You know, I went over there and to see two dudes on the mic. They was doing their thing, and the DJ behind, he got two records repeating the beats. He was taking those two records and he was being a whole band. And then he's cutting the records and I'm like, I was amazed. And I'll never forget those dudes was called Kid Flash and the Almighty Fly MCs.
That's what they do.
They was called Kid Flash and the Almighty Fly MCs. And one dude named was Fly, he Ray Vaughn. And I remember telling Ray Vaughn that he was a star to me. And he was like, man, go ahead. He was like, this is, and I asked him what it was. And he was like, this is hip hop. Because I always thought he was one of the coolest dudes because he was from Rum Projects, but he was dating a girl in my project.
Yeah.
And so, you know, time went on. It was about a year and a half in. And I never forget, I rapped for his girlfriend. I was like, tell Flyheem I'm coming. So she thought it was cute. So I was coming out of the building one day with my mother. And you know, you with your mom, so you like, you know, because your mom was like, and I remember Tracy doing on Flyheem. And he was like, yeah, he was like little Charlie B bad. And she named him Charlie. I'm like, Charlie B, she was like, little Charlie B bad, he on your ass. So he was like, let me hear some. And I looked at my mom's and my mom's was like, go ahead, get it. So they gave you like,
yeah.
And I spit my little rhyme. And he was like, all right, my man, you good. So at 11 I started, but I never forget, one of my biggest climaxes was 13. And I was at the Cold Crush Brother versus the Force MCs.
Wow.
That was at CCP Rec. I was there. I was hip hop then. Kango, British Walkers. I was all in then.
They're calling British Walkers.
Yeah, British Walkers.
Like, okay, we call
them British. They were like before Wallabies.
Yeah. Okay.
You see me where I'm talking
about.
Yeah,
okay, okay.
So, you know, I'm all out there, Lee suit, my jean suit, all airbrushed up and chilling. And Flyheem and them was on stage. And they was rocking. I mean, they was rocking. And you never forget the first time. Flyheem was like, yo, I got my man, my little homeboy. He's like, Charlie B, come on up there. They hit it. I start rapping. Everybody was crazy. They're like, we know you can rap. Everybody went crazy. And then my man's, that I love him to death, DJ Cool T. Now that's the DJ. He was like, yo, I heard you could cut too. And they let me, you know, cut. Let me cut. From there, he was on it popping.
That's what they did.
He was on it popping. Like, it was, and people that know me was like, yo, it went crazy. Like, it was people. I battled KRS-One before KRS-One. Like, we was in New York, we was doing it.
That's classic shit, man.
I battled King's Son. Me and King's Son used to get it. Like, I battled cats. I battled Kool Moe
D. Only back in traffic, man. Classic shit, man.
I battled Kool Moe D. 1986, Hinch Cliff Stadium, never forget it. Like I said, I got some joints under my belt. And,
got some more to put up under there?
Yeah, I ain't done. I just, like, the rapping, I still got it. I love that. I just keep that as a secret weapon. But, like, rocking a party, it ain't nothing like rocking a party. But I come from the era of my most monumental moments. And a lot of people might go, why? I come from the era of being a DJ behind rap groups.
Yeah.
I just think that I'm a master of that. Like, man, Allah bless him, how Jam Master Jay was.
Right.
Jam Master Jay was the master of Run DMC. They could say, I want to do this, but your DJ reads the crap.
Yeah.
And me and you been together many shows where I've changed the whole entire show.
He changed the whole set. And went from the bottom to the top. I don't get ready to say this shit. You're like, nah, I think hold up.
Nah. But the fact of it,
I appreciate works. That shit. Hey, yeah, it worked. You know, money. Right. Oh, that's, yeah, they didn't talk. Go, nigga. Take money, go.
And I like I tell cats, it's good to have show mixes. But when you a group's DJ, have the individual song too, because it'll show. Because when a show mix, you gotta go according to the show mix.
Right.
But if you got individual songs, you can go all over that most, like boom, 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 and you did the same show, but just in different, a different format.
Right.
And I tell a lot of groups, I tell a lot of people, get you a DJ. Get you a personal DJ. Now, it don't matter. It's all right sometimes if the artist go out and do a venue.
You think some of the artists even want to get DJs right now? Like, I think they so to the point where they just want to rap. You know what I'm saying? So I think it's right. Even a DJ, from a DJ point of view, because I was a lot of DJs out here now. Why they don't think they try to reach out to artists?
Because that? A lot of artists don't like to share the spotlight. See, when we was coming up, it was the DJ name and then the artist name. You feel where I'm coming from?
Yeah.
It was Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five, DJ Easy Lee and the Church Was Three, Charlie Chase, Tony Tone, and the Cold Crush Brothers.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? At the 90s came, let's go to the best one of hip hop, DJ Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince. As let me say what killed the DJ. And this is honest. Hip hop destroyed is my top dog. Cause guess what? I'm your DJ, but when you go to do a song in the studio, all I get to do is sit there. You doing all the work.
True.
So record labels go what we need him for.
Gotcha.
A lot of DJs' names not even on the record.
Technology's switched up a whole lot of stuff.
Right. Mm-hmm. So now, but this is what we're going to go back. Now, people, like, I'm going to say Houdini. Houdini was the first who did it. You know, their DJ was Grandmaster D. Houdini said, okay, listen, we going in, we're going to take D from in front, and we're just going to be Houdini. So when they signed this Houdini, they all three signed in the group, because they told them, our DJ is part of this group.
What's that mean?
Because when we go on tour, okay, we got to make a record, but how do we recoup the money? Going out there, record sales ain't going to just recoup all the money.
Right.
So they had to go out there, boom, recoup the money. Now you need your DJ. But the sad part is your DJ ain't getting none of the, only DJ that's getting money off of the labels was Houdini and Mathematics. Wu-Tang DJ, Wu-Tang DJ stood by their DJ.
So most of the DJs are right now doing shows and stuff like that. They doing like, what do you call it, work for hire contracts? They're not doing, you know,
yeah, they just doing like, work for hire.
Why you think that's something? Why wouldn't the artists, they said, that's how you're doing your shows and shit, why not go ahead and include them in it, you know what I'm saying?
And then if you look, well, that's the, I don't even know.
That's what you're getting the show. I mean, that's what you
get. Yeah, you do the artist behind, because the DJ, like he said, when they put the music out, they ain't going to put them on a full-fledged contract unless you're a show enough DJ. And now the mixtape DJs, you don't even hear that no more because we ain't got the damn mixtapes no more.
Right.
You know, you got Spotify, Apple, all of that, then, you know.
Man, that's bring that shit back, man. Think about it. You ain't shit without a DJ.
Yeah.
You gotta have a DJ, because this will break the record. Right? I think that's what a lot of artists feel like with probably too, because they feel like they ain't gonna break the record anymore.
Right. But they, and I tell artists all the time, because they try to follow that with DJs, and I'm like, if y'all follow that with the DJs in these clubs, where y'all going to do your showcases or open mics or whatever you want to call it, you can't follow that with them DJs, because them the ones that's getting booked, going to this club, going to that club, and if they fool with you and like your music, they gonna play it in different clubs. So now you got different people clicking on your stuff.
Right.
You know, but once you start falling out with the DJs, as they want to call them local DJs, them the ones who start really breaking your record up.
Right.
And they do, but see, I want people to understand, and I'm glad you brought us up here, we're talking about hip hop.
Yeah.
I know both of y'all movie connoisseurs. I'm around you guys. Let's say Cadillac Records, let's say the Temptations movie, let's say the Five Heartbeats. We all familiar with that, right?
Right.
Okay. Hip hop is the only genre who feels that they don't owe nobody nothing back. We feel that we are above everything. Now, while I'm getting at those three movies, in each one of those movies I named, it was a scene where somebody from the record label walked up in a DJ booth or in a radio station with the record, broke some payola. Could you play that?
That's still going on.
It's still going to the end. But hip hop feels, nah, you just gonna play my drum.
You talking about your boy?
No, I'm not even getting that much illegal. But look at back then, that country didn't mind paying, R&B didn't mind paying, doo-wop didn't, you know what I'm saying? This is, but when it get to us, no. No. You had our black brothers and sisters on white radio stations. If you didn't pay, it was no way in hell some of these records would have got broke. Sure. But they failed to realize that. But money is power.
It takes a lot of money to break a record nowadays.
Money is power.
It takes a lot to get a record.
They say 200,000. $200,000 break the break radio. So do you think you felt you really needed with all these? Because right now, I'm saying what was breaking records off the influence.
And really with radio, a lot of people not even listening to like the regular radio no more. A lot of people got their telephones or if they're in their car, they got the Sirius XM or whatever, Spotify, YouTube, whatever music platform. A lot of people not even listening to the regular radio.
I'm watching motherfuckers pay like random motherfuckers, 20 on Facebook shit. So you got like influencers. My mama had like 100,000 followers. Say shit, give me $20, or I'll promote this and do that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, and it's about reaching direct, going direct to the fans. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And that is easy for you to go just to whatever music site you want to and type in somebody and you listen to their music there. You know, so you're no longer having to go into the stores and do all this and do all that.
So basically, now DJ basically got to go live with this shit.
Yeah, you got to go live.
And then play like that. And that's, I mean, it's another way to break records because, I mean, you know, you're following the show like that because that's the world they grew up in.
Yeah.
This shit is right here.
Yeah.
So, like I said, I'm saying, you reach the masses, you're going to play it. So you think radio going to be extinct soon? You think it's all right?
I ain't going to say it's going to be extinct, but the radio ain't the radio like the world move coming up.
Yeah.
You know, the radio ain't the radio no more. You know, and it's good if you get your music on the radio, but a lot of people not. Our generation, we still following the radio. We're still throwing some radio here and there. Yeah. But our children, you know, the younger generation, what they call them, X, the little crazy motherfuckers. Yeah. But you know, they do everything as social media.
Right.
Everything is so they can visually see, I'm gonna type this in, I can go and do my workout, I ain't gotta have no Walkman, you know, I ain't gotta worry about my tape popping, now I ain't gotta go buy me an anti-skip CD player. Remember then when you used to jog and your CD player just get to skipping and skipping?
Yeah, yeah.
Or if you're walking too fast, you know, so now everything is just straight through, but it's robbing the artist too.
True.
I look at robbing the hell out of these artists because if somebody buy your single, when you coming up and you had the tapes or you had CDs, you were physically getting paid some money.
Right.
If somebody got a single for you, could sell it for $1. That dollar will come into you.
Right.
But now with streaming, you're not even getting. You sell it for $1, you might not even get 15 cents off that dollar.
Right. You get any, right? Might get
you know, so everybody that got there and downloaded your music and
listening for free.
Right. The labels I got there and recouping because they selling all the ads.
Right.
You know, they got there and got all these people coming in. We're gonna pay you this for this amount of time to put it on different videos and different songs. You know, do a little break in between and if you need this, if you need that, call such and such. You know.
So what do you think? Do you think artists right now, where the game is now, you think artists still need to be looking to get signed or keep it independent?
To be honest, I always say artists need, if you don't have a big following in the beginning, go to a label. Do you a one or two album deal. The label will put all the work behind you. Once you start getting your numbers up and your fan base up, after that second one, you can leave the label and go independent because you got your fan base. But the label did everything that needed to be done. They got everywhere with the promotional packages and sending it, you all the way to South Dakota, straight out of North Carolina. Right. Ain't never been to South Dakota, but your music in South Dakota.
True.
You can go and do a show in South Dakota because that major that was behind you pushed you because they want to make some money. They want to recoup their money.
You already know.
So they're going to make sure they promote you properly. You know, so I say do a 1 or 2 album deal, and then once you get there, fuck the majors. You know, and then go independent.
But that you nailed it. That's all people need to know, because everything is independent is the way to go. I'm gonna break it down another way. You know how many big people that's been doing radio all their life, now they got podcasts. They keep it now, like Angie Martinez, biggest radio personality in New York. She still has her show on radio, but now Revolt gave her a podcast deal. So she living the best of both worlds, because now I could book you to come on my radio show. Because you got to be booked through the radio station.
Right.
Let the radio station book the artist to come on a radio show, right?
Right.
Now, once you get there, we got a good repertoire and a good understanding, right? We people. Now, I'm going to book you to come to my podcast. I get 2 for them paying for 1.
Right. You got that shit right.
2 monies.
So like Faye said, in the beginning, you need a machine.
You need a machine. I look at a lot of artists and they say they don't need no team. And they just need just them and 1 other person. You can't do that, not these days, because you need somebody to be able to film you while you record. You can't film your damn self. Mm-hmm. What are you going to do, put the phone up or your camera up and say, okay, I'm going to sit right here and I'm going to perform from here. But then they can't see the fans. They can't see nobody interacting. So you got to have your cameraman.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, you want to have a DJ. If you're doing like live sets, because DJ gonna get everybody crunk.
Right.
Once you get to a certain spot, you want to be a publicist, because some of y'all can rap, but some of y'all can't talk worth a damn.
Don't know what to say.
Don't know how to articulate your words. You come from the hood, you stay talking hood. So once you start getting a certain spot, you need to get a publicist. You know, and before you start signing these contracts, get you a goddamn lawyer. An entertainment lawyer, not a hood lawyer that got their
paralegal.
Yeah, or a paralegal, get you an entertainment lawyer. It's gonna cost you a little change, but you know, if you really want to get in this game, man, you gotta make sure you got all your I's dotted and your T's crossed.
Right, better than I've been.
You know, because you know, I always tell people it's an entertainment business, and a lot of folks remember entertainment if we get the business part.
All right,
of course.
So let me ask you another question on the side note. How the show come in? Let's talk about y'all show, man. What's up with y'all with the Party Punisher? What's going on?
Which one? The Party Punisher TV show? The Party Punisher radio show?
That's what I'm saying.
The Pussy Punisher show? You know, which one?
Oh, I think I'm a shower cap too. Appreciate it.
Oh, yeah. You know, and we get ready to bring them.
I'm a shower cap.
We get ready to bring those back.
Hey, I got my cap.
You got your cap.
I got my cap.
Yeah,
we got
your
cap. But, I'm glad you asked that. I'm glad Fitch broke it down like that. We got 3 shows, actually.
Right,
we got the Party Punisher TV show.
Okay.
We got the Party Punisher radio show.
Okay.
And we still do the Pussy Punisher show. You know, we do that. Matter of fact, our last guest was incredible. I'm going to just clap for that. Our last guest was incredible. I love her so much.
What my last guest was? Yeah, you left some good mark, goddamn it.
Hey. But all of those are going good. I mean, you know, the Party Punisher TV show, radio show, those are through Connected, Entertainment and Wellness
Center. Shout out Connected.
KG, my man, you're holding us down. The Pussy Punisher, that's through Visuals by Face.
All right.
That's through Visuals by Face. They're all going great, because we just had Goddess on our TV show and radio show. And for a young lady that's 5 years old, she is better than some grown adults that have been on our show.
Yeah. That's sit up and said the publicist.
Yeah.
But I say Muscle and Miss Betty Ford got her right. They got her right.
That's what's up. Shout out to Muscle and Miss Betty Ford, man. Hood Bound, what's
happening? Hood Bound.
For real.
But yeah, you got to, man. You got to have somebody to help you talk, because some of these jokes don't know how to talk, and they're talking their way out of a deal.
Yeah.
They're talking their way out of a deal, because they say, boy, they're entertainment, they can rap, they got some nice lyrics, but that joke is dumb as a box of rock. So, you know, sometimes...
Shit, they might be around the sound just because of that fucking reason.
Yeah, so, you know, sometimes you just got to make sure you got the right team, though.
You got to, let's see.
And also, because I heard you talking about the three shows, we're getting ready to start filming probably next month, waiting on some more donations to come through from the church folk. Yeah. You know, but we're getting ready to start shooting our salvation.
What's that about?
Oh, that's the church.
That's the church.
We, as long as you come.
Okay.
We just want them to come.
All right.
And then come again. You know, and it's
on the corner where?
69 and Conolingus Avenue. So we just need them to come. That's all.
What kind of church? What's the religion?
Salvations. That's the religion.
Okay.
As long as they salivate,
we speak on coming.
Yeah, the power of the tongue. The power of the tongue. The power of the tongue.
Wasn't that?
We didn't say that.
We didn't say that. We just said come. Now you said busting. You said that.
These niggas talking about busting nuts. What the hell y'all talking about?
The power of the tongue.
We said it.
It's a salvation.
Man, that's running niggas too long. What the hell y'all got your phone in
there? That's Reverend Face to see.
And you remember?
And I'm
fast. I'm sweeping the fuck out of here.
I'm fast. I'm Reverend Face.
Yeah, I know it's a man. What's on the back of the box?
It's nothing. We just want you to come.
You know what I'm saying? Thank you, motherfuckers.
Just come.
Hey, y'all need to thank you guys.
You have to watch the first episode to see.
Yeah, but Saturday, y'all need to come.
You have to watch the first episode.
Man, y'all play too goddamn well. Y'all
need to play. The first episode.
I remember this. No. Hey, no fucking way. Y'all play too goddamn well.
I'm dead serious.
Salivation, my motherfucking ass.
Yeah, salivation.
Alright.
It's coming soon, man.
AKA Scar Steve. You got that. Y'all ain't fooling me, goddamn. See, who they y'all think y'all start? Church. Tabernacle on that. I know, goddamn. Y'all ain't fooling me, goddamn. I was born tonight, not last night. Man, I'm talking to OG Faze, Nicolo Sun. Y'all got me fucked up. Like, I knew the fuck up. Man, I been out here by this for real.
The name of the show.
Y'all niggas stupid.
It's called
Salivating Salvation. So y'all get ready to be
Salivating Salvation.
Yeah, Salivating Salvation.
Pull up in your SS and watch what happens.
Yeah, Salivating Salvation is on the corner of 69 Cummins and Conolingus Avenue.
Yeah, that's ready. Do you mean the address, man?
Yeah, 69 Cummins and Conolingus Avenue. That's the address for Salivating Salvation.
Y'all motherfuckers crazy, man.
Hey. I've been crazy.
But y'all have to change, man.
It's our new show.
Yes, Salvation.
Hey, y'all hear me? But somebody gonna get pregnant.
So we're gonna be looking for some parishioners.
Y'all got the cooking my come through.
We just need parishioners to come. Just come. Come as you are. Just come.
Hey, well, y'all ain't gonna win with these niggas here, man. There's no way out, man.
I mean, that's all, man. We are y'all here. Change. We are here. To make a better community.
That's all.
We want everybody to be happy.
This is what happened on Mackin and Trevor. See how they think these niggas are here,
and as long as you come, you'll be happy. You know.
So. Man, this ain't come be happy.
Yeah, come be happy.
Preach.
But just come.
Just come.
That's the hey. Main thing, you know.
These niggas pay too much.
Now, hold up. Let's get back on this topic before he go cuckoo over here.
Y'all was crazy.
I like to enlighten people too.
Niggas too, man.
See, a lot of people talk about, you know, Jay-Z. Jay-Z is the number one businessman in hip hop right now.
Y'all call him crazy.
You got to be.
He got good, got dirty.
Oh, come on, yeah, okay.
Dirty, yeah.
Okay. I ain't even that.
Yeah, number one in hip hop when it comes to business. Y'all can call that man crazy.
Yeah, I ain't gonna debate with that. But where I was going with it was, a lot of people think that he just did it. Like when Rockefeller came on. Like that was it. No. People don't understand, like labels, even before he went independent, he was signed to that label with Jazzo. They had a song called Hawaiian Soul. Mm-hmm. Then before Jazzo, people don't know that Jay-Z was signed with Cold Chillin' because he used to open up for Big Daddy Kane. So he went through the machine. He knew what it took to move the machine.
So once he figured it out,
Once he figured it out, and he got with some cats that knew what to do, and they took the game like Faye said, they hustled themselves. Then you let suffer the product.
You better.
And then look at Rockefeller. But the thing with Rockefeller was, sometimes you let the wrong people into your circle. Because see, Dame was the type to open up the door and want everybody come in. You can't let everybody in. That's just like me. It be certain cats, I'm like, you that dude fire. Let me face it though. Just something about him that rubbed me the wrong way, so nah, he can't be no punisher.
Definitely understand that. About the energy, man.
Yeah, I come here, you know, shit, no disrespect. I love all y'all, but I said on TV, some of you damn punishers need to go.
Hold on, man.
This is a Joker moment. Hey,
hold on. I need my sound effect with that motherfucker. Hold on, man. A lot of groups and shit like that in the Carolinas, man, but I'm trying to see where the movement is.
If you're talking about the Coalition DJs, I rock with them. The Coalition DJs are my people.
And they still doing the press box right on Sundays, right?
No, that's not the Coalition.
Mike Scott's still doing it, right?
Yeah, that's Mike Scott.
Shout out to Mike Scott, man.
Yeah, shout out Mike Scott. Mike Scott, my man. Mike Scott, my man. Actually, Mike Scott be DJing on.
You ready to join?
At the 49th anniversary.
Let's talk about that while we're on that. I see you got a lot of this man. Who are you got showing up, man?
I got
Well, he ain't trying to forget nobody, but we just got down, man, some Carolina shit, man.
Yeah. I got
Hey, he's Murphy that good.
Because the door just opened up. Like,
oh.
Yeah.
What you need,
man? Are y'all fly?
Yeah. You good? We just magazine traffic.
Which is a hooker, a small hooker.
Show me which one I'm talking about, because I got a couple small ones, one of those small ones. And a little clip, the white box.
Yeah, and then there's one in the front boxes, a little bigger, and then there's a little white.
The little white one is 25, the other one 30. You can tell them the big boxes, you tell them the two small ones.
The itty bitty ones is like probably like 10, 15, something like that.
Oh, the real small one is 25. The one, the other one in the little blue box is 30.
See, we back in traffic live on air. We don't play them games. We get the traffic out
there.
We get it out. It's not I. I'm gonna tell. We got DJ Darth Vader. DJ Darth Vader. He's 53 years old. We got
DJ Black.
We got DJ Black, 54 years old, out of High Point. Crazy. Crazy. The energy is gonna knock you off your feet. Matter of fact, I'm gonna hit you with man. DJ Black is Taliban for Money Moves Father.
Straight up. Hey, that's what's up.
The energy that Taliban got on the mic, his father got on the ones and twos.
Hey, shout out to Taliban, my nigga Taliban.
Yeah, but a lot of folks don't know about Taliban. He's a Taliban, started as a DJ.
He started as a DJ.
I didn't even know that.
Yeah, Taliban was a DJ at first before he started.
Taliban, you tell me that, man.
Yeah, Taliban was a DJ.
We got DJ. We got DJ T.O.P. The youngest in
charge of T.O.P., man. Yeah,
He coming.
For sure.
We got my partner who I started
the party. You know, T.O.P. made that moonshine beat.
I heard.
T.O.P.
My late father told me,
Yeah, T.O.P. made that beat.
Who started the Party Punishers with me? Ecstatic DJ Q Mix.
Oh man, Q Mix was bad.
Q Mix,
Q Mix on the sneaker cons too, man. Boy, we
see going on, boy.
He been killing
the sneaker.
And he paid that big dog over there. I think on the way was in Chicago somewhere. Hey man, love you, Q Mix, man. You my dog, man.
My man. This how you know you old school. DJ Rexki.
Rexki with the name Rexki, you
know that's old school.
Rexki, you know that's old school.
Rexki, I said we got DJ Mike Scott, we got DJ Supreme from out of Gastonia.
That's what
you gonna remember my old school? We bringing DJ Facade.
Oh come on, that's my dog, man.
Facade gonna be there.
Sorry, what's happening? Yeah, yeah.
Let me get over here. Ah, let me get.
It's gonna be a dope event, man. It's gonna be dope, man.
If y'all ain't been out to Connected Center yet, man, go out there and check it out, man. It's dope.
We got DJ LeBron gonna be there.
And LeBron's a
beast.
That would do it.
We got
DJ. And his daughter, she's a heck of an entertainer as well.
Right, she sings.
Yeah.
Rexki, performing. Your boy coming back out. My son, Dun Dada.
Man, Dun Dada, what's happening? Stop, man. Tell us to get in the studio, man. Stop playing, man. And my dog.
Who else we got?
Got OG Poop.
OG Poop.
Shout out, Poop. Poop, what's up, nigga? Tell you stop playing. Let's go to work, man. Stop playing, Poop.
You know we got yourself. Love Bone will be hitting the stage.
You know we're there talking
we got the youngest in charge. She going to be hitting the stage.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Goddess.
Yeah.
We got Silky Jones in the
city. Man, OG Silk was hanging.
OG, one of the first ones in the city.
Hey, Space Big, we're talking about you the other day.
Silk. One of the first
ones. Hey, we got Space Bigger, bigger, man. Space, you've been trying to, he been talking about you the other day, man. He talked good. How do you, Silk? My motherfucking dog, man. Shout out to Space Bigger the other day.
Yeah, and then we got something that's just going to make me feel so good. We got Cut Lord Swift. That's EPMD DJ.
Man, that's what's up, man.
And we got, I'm going to show you how we digging. We got Gabby the Gift that used to be on the Dave Chappelle show.
That's what's up, man. Hey, if y'all want to come to this event, man, August 13th. Man, tell me about the event, man. What's going on?
August 13th, man, it's going down big. The Connected Entertainment and Wellness Center. Live out there in Salisbury, North Carolina. With Sound Enlightened by my man Tone. If you ever went to a concert and had this type of sound, it's incredible. It's the Party Punishers and the Connected. We giving 49 year anniversary of hip hop. We got DJs, MCs, graffiti artists, break dancers, and beatboxers. It's gonna be incredible. And if you want a vent, reach out to Kevin Glover. Reach out to Kevin Glover. And man, we're gonna have a great time. Doors open at 5, show starts at 5:45.
And ain't nobody killing y'all on the vending fees neither.
No.
You ain't gonna have to pay no honey, no 75, all of that. You get you a nice little.
Go ahead, Tom.
Go ahead, because I'm gonna be there. Magic Traffic and the Shades Line gonna be there. Y'all already know what time it is.
So we ain't killing nobody on the vendor price.
And there's plenty of space. I'm gonna tell you that, because I done did. Plenty of space out there too. Set it where you want to sit, man, it's dope.
It's dope.
It's dope, man.
It's going down.
Stage straight, your height straight, it's wide enough to, man, it's wide enough for you to perform and do what the fuck you do. If you don't have fun on that stage, you're fucking up. It's your fault.
Exactly.
Right. If you don't have fun on the stage, you're fucking up. That's your fault.
That's your fault. That's your fault.
Toss the stage down.
The stage is there.
Yeah. Heck of a stage.
The stage is there. The sound is there, everything. I can tell you from the out of the mouth. I just did.
And the sun ain't going to kill you.
No. But bring your own chairs.
Yeah, bring
your own chair.
Bring your own chairs.
And if you want an interview on the Mackin Trick Podcast, you better holler at me, shoot me the DM. It's going down. The Shade Designs will be there. For real. Shit. What else is going to fit? What you got cracking? I know you're saying all types of
man,
shit.
Man, you know, August 27th, I've been in talks with in Libyan.
What's that?
They were the housing authority in Libyan. It's over housing authority now. So I had a meeting with them yesterday, putting this back to school drive together and just making sure we can use some of their properties, you know, where the apartments are, just to make sure we got our everything proper, you know, so we'll be able to do the back to school drive in some of those locations.
Oh, that's hey, back to school. Hey, man, we got a box up here to Shade Design, too, man. So y'all want to donate?
Yeah, so that's...
Hit me on DM, man. Come donate, man. Back to school shit, man.
We're doing one kid, August, man. August 27th. It'll be from 1 to 4 at, in Cedar Knoll Apartments, right up the road.
Southside.
Right up, yeah, Southside, S4.
All right.
You know, it's always 4-way or nowhere. You know? Real. You can't say Sam O 4 without the 4. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about? In the real 4. But I ain't going to get in all that. But
they big about that.
Yeah. Ain't gonna get into all that though. Well, hey,
man.
Know what
y'all need to get together, man. Pick up this phone, man.
Yeah, but
shout out to my nigga Flat Nose too, man.
Yeah, me and Flat, I tell you, me and him started the 4-way or no way. That's my dog down and dirty. Oh, but yeah. yeah. But
the 10 man been in the 4. I told you I've been out here, partner.
Yeah, but we're gonna be doing that the 27th of this month.
Okay.
And it's gonna be from 1 to 4 p.m. Myself, my son's mother, who he was deceased. He died 2 years ago. But we have she started an organization called Jay's Big Give Back in His Remembrance. So
okay.
Me and her teaming up this year to do a big book bag drive, because usually I do it, you know, myself. This will be my 8th year doing it, right. You know. Even during the pandemic, I was rocking it. But this year, we can't do it in my old community where I grew up at, Winston Trails. You know, because his other folks about to settle. I ain't gonna say what ethnicity, but some other people about to settle, so we can't no longer use the center for the book bag donation. So
okay.
I wanted to keep it on the south side, so I reached out. You know, we reached out to Cedar Knoll Apartments. So
that's what's up.
We'll be there August 27th from 1 to 4, you know, giving stuff out to the kids and then having a you know, have some food out there. You know, I'm gonna mess a grill up.
All right.
You know, and have a couple performances from some of the children artists, you know, and just allow them to have a good time. They last big shindig before they go back to school. See, I'm country, because you ain't heard shindig in a minute, have
you? Yeah, I know.
Yeah, so they can have they last
big shindig. Let me ask you a question. I've been watching the news lately, man. This shit crazy. And what's up with this monkeypox shit, man?
Man, I don't know. Shit. I had chicken pox, so I'm like, I can get monkey pox.
Man, that's
I had chicken pox.
In the state of emergency, you know, kind of shit.
Yeah, in New York.
In the country, it's state of emergency.
It's state of the monkey pox. But this, it has so many people put out there so many different meanings of what monkey pox is. You don't even know what to believe.
You don't know what monkey pox is, but I think it's just goddamn chicken pox coming back around. Because I look at the monkey pox, chicken pox didn't get that big, but I remember being broke all out on your face and in your head, and you know.
I mean, chicken meat, all that is just only black people.
I don't know.
I'm turning the wrong channel. What the fuck I'm looking at? But every time I turn, they was showing a black face, but they got
the with the monkey pox. So I don't know.
And they're trying to be funny.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Then they call it monkey pox. That.
Yeah, and I'm calling it monkey pox. I don't even want a joke of eating a banana around me right now. I don't even want a joke of eating a banana around me right now, because I'm gonna get nervous.
Yo, where are you crazy as hell?
Eating a banana around.
Mm-mm.
Yo, you said you don't want a joke.
Mm-mm.
So what y'all think? So y'all think Kobe gone?
No, yeah. COVID ain't went nowhere.
I think they gonna shut down by November, man.
Nah,
They ain't gonna shut down. They're not as business smart to do it without Trump. See, Trump, even though Trump was giving out money, he knew what the back end was going to bring back.
Right.
Yeah.
Look at it now. Me and Faith was just driving. Yesterday, was it yesterday or the day before yesterday? They paid you $20 an hour there with McDonald's.
Yeah, we was Concord.
$20 an hour.
They paid $20 an hour at Mickey D's, at McNegro's.
That's been even that shit went up.
That was in Concord.
Yesterday.
That was yesterday.
God, yeah, damn.
Wednesday.
Shit, Wednesday. Y'all been stopping working.
Well, yesterday, because that's when I was in the mall with the girl yesterday.
$20 an hour.
Yeah.
Hey. Well, Ronald McDonald bullshit, I'm sure getting big and red.
Well, I remember I started at McDonald's, we were making $5.75.
Oh, wow, that shit.
Making $5.75.
When I did it was $8. No, $8. It was seven something.
$5.75.
It's $20. It's big. What you call that shit? The marquee.
Yeah.
$20 an hour.
Yeah, they paid $20 down the Concord. I say shit.
Hey, somebody about to go holler at the art.
Yeah.
Give me some big red shoes.
Hello, may I take your order?
For real? Do you want extra cheese on them? Hey, now you're going to read the paper with the goddamn sauce. Give me my goddamn sweet and sour sauce, man.
Yep. And fix them damn ice cream machines.
Yeah.
Fix that motherfucker.
Okay, another thing. The mother always asking what we got going on. So, you know, we got the Party Punisher TV show, Party Punisher radio show. We got the Pussy Punisher show. We got the Salvation's show get ready to come up. We got visuals by Face. We got the gentleman and the gangster production get ready to come out. And we got Face's Kitchen that we get ready to start recording that. And we also get ready to come out with an all natural line. You know, I used to bang out real hard with the shea butters and mango butters and all, so we're gonna get back into that, bring all natural back. But one of our babies will be rebirthed, and Face and myself have a blessing, even with our big brother, with Alexa, will be opened up this month, August.
Oh, what's the name of it now?
Alexa.
Okay.
Yeah, Alexa, grown up over there. We'll be opening back up. We'll be opening back up this month. So once we open up, we're doing a soft opening at first, and then we're gonna reopen all the way. The food's gonna be marvelous.
Alrighty.
Because it's gonna be a four-star chef in the kitchen. You know,
can I get my special drink, man? Can I create something in? Put it up.
We'll.
I know how you do. Right, that's why I said it, bro. I know how you do, nigga.
So we'll be
stay with the drink.
Elixir Lounge.
For real.
Elixir Lounge will be.
That's what's up, man. Yeah. That's what muscle was having, man. That's what's up.
Yeah, we're going to have a four-star chef in the kitchen, man. So
that's what we do, man.
Big move!
Oh, I know what I meant to tell you. Video shoot Saturday. Cadillac Slim Lounge, man. Tequila shots. 7 p.m.
I got to go to Slim Lounge, man. I seen him the other night. Yeah. Cadillac, if you're looking for, I got to come out there.
Yeah.
Well, we'll come out there after, because we work inside there.
We're working with the Union, with the Charlotte City workers.
Oh, that was it. Man, Grind don't stop. That's what it do.
Grind don't never stop.
Don't never fucking stop. Yeah, also, the short films on YouTube, man. Shout out to Chase Boy TV, man. All or Nothing and Better the Beast, man. Y'all go check them shits out on YouTube, too, man. Short film doing numbers on the short film, man. Shout out to Chase Boy TV.
Oh, yeah. Which one is that when you the pet?
Oh, that's a Better the Beast.
I love that joint.
Then y'all check it out. The
other one is All or Nothing.
All or Nothing. That one I'm playing Pocket
Chicken,
me and Break Bread.
And go on Tubi, man, because we're doing a lot of stuff down here in the CAC, man.
And shout out to Marcus Madsen, man.
Yeah,
Tubi, man.
Go to Tubi.
The Last Days of
Black Rob, man. Yeah, man. Go to Tubi.
Shout out to OG Madsen.
Go watch that, man. Shout out to Marcus. Muscle, everybody on.
Yes, sir.
You know, and then go check out. Since we're talking about movies, go check out that God City.
Oh, for real. And it's still on Amazon.
Yeah, it's on Amazon Prime, on Tubi. You know, go check out that God City, man. And for everybody want to say why we God City, because it's G the 7th letter. the O, and then the D is the fourth letter. We ain't nothing but God. You know what I'm talking about?
Big was talking about it the other day.
You know, so the guy said it, man.
That's what I tell everybody. You got the G, which is the seventh letter, the O, which is the 15th letter, and the D, which is the four. You understand what I'm saying? So you take 7 and 15 is what?
22.
22 and 4 is what?
26.
2 and 6 is what?
8.
Okay. 704. When you break all that down, it goes all the way back to the 8 because 704 builds and destroys everything. It either elevates you or deteriorates you, depending on yourself.
If you turn this 8 sideways, isn't that offended?
Always. See, there's many ways to break down knowledge.
Yep.
That we call it Mackin the traffic makers. You never know, but you're going to learn something from.
There's always many ways to break down knowledge. I'm loving this mountain nigga, though, what you see for you.
It's that mountain nigga.
That's what it do, man. See, this is what's going on Mackin the traffic, man. We only talk about the hip-hop, man. We educate, man, and we do a lot of stuff on Mackin the traffic, man. This shit is that way we call it Mackin the traffic. You never know who you're going to see in front of this motherfucking camera. You know what I'm talking about?
Man, you had a big boy, man. Big boy, man.
I got to say this right quick.
Happy birthday, Big Sir 50, man.
Yeah, but somebody had set up and said Trump was trying to bankrupt the economy. He didn't try to bankrupt the economy. It wasn't on him. Y'all gonna leave Trump alone. If Trump was home, I bet that girl wouldn't be over there in Russia.
That's bullshit. Free Britney, man.
But some got there smoke.
Free Britney. That ain't no fucking smoke, a fucking pen, man.
Yeah, pen. That's what I'm saying, for some smoke.
Come on, man.
You know, that's crazy. 9 years.
That's some bullshit,
so,
man.
All y'all wanting to go outside of America and go here
that's
and go there
Free Britney,
and talk shit about this country, we got a lot of shit that goes on here.
Yeah.
But we ain't getting no 9 years for no goddamn vape pen.
Hell, man.
I tell you that goddamn money.
Man, you got that shit right
you
there.
You know, our country doesn't treat us properly. Us lower income folk, but I don't want to go no damn way else.
Let me tell you that, but people talk on that talk. I don't give a damn how big I get. I'm not leaving here. Like Lil Wayne said, I'm not going nowhere. You know what that dude? The man kept away. He liked to smoke. He liked to do different.
They want to catch you. Just like that damn
And then if they found out you got a name, we really gonna have a ball with you.
Because they were gonna release her.
Exactly.
They were gonna release her back here, but we gonna have to get them an arms dealer. And America didn't want a bad one going for that. I say, I need to know what's going on with bad. This joker getting the railroad too damn much. Anytime you turn around, he got COVID.
I don't know, but I seen the follow that guy in the bicycle.
Then he followed off a stationary bicycle that ain't even damn moving. You gotta keep it. Man, what's really going on?
And why they keep hiding Kamala, man? When the fuck she come out every day? Once every 6 months?
Who?
Kamala, Ms. Harris.
Who?
Oh, my bad.
Oh,
Mike Jones, dude.
Oh, okay. Well, is it Kamala or Kamala?
I don't fucking know.
I don't know what the hell.
Kamala, Kamala, either one on deal.
The woman that married
to Brittany, man.
The woman who married to the white man.
Yeah, whatever her name is, because she wasn't African-American.
Oh, I know what was fucked up, though. What about the wife of the motherfucking Supreme Court judge? The motherfucking, the wife that's doing the business, doing the dirty shit. Supreme Court judge, all the black, the only I think
you know who Clarence.
Clarence Thomas. Yeah, what's up with that shit, man?
Yeah, Clarence Thomas, and you can't say black man, because Clarence ain't never been black. I think Clarence, you remember that Chappelle skit?
Yeah. Right?
When Chappelle was the Klan.
Yeah.
He couldn't see. That what was his name? Dixby. that's Clarence Thomas. That's Clarence Thomas.
Well, yeah.
He's Dixby.
Alright, before I can put another question for y'all, because I see y'all did y'all travel, man. How y'all feel about what's going on right now with Carolina as far as the underground scene, the music scene, the support system, the ecosystem right in Carolina as far as the entertainment? How y'all feel about it? What's going on right now? Are we growing or we just gonna...
We growing a little bit, but everybody has to start supporting each other, man. Because I can look at... You can put a Carolina showcase together. Not no major artist. I ain't gonna say no one who's made it to the A's level or B level. But you put some seeing down... artists together, you ain't gonna get that many people in the house. But if we all support each other, you can start making them numbers, and once promoters start seeing you can pack the house, but that takes all the artists to get together, to work together. Let's start filling this little venue up. They gotta be big venues. If you got a hundred seater and promoters start seeing you can fill that up, they're gonna start coming to holler at y'all. But artists need to realize everybody gotta work together, man. Everybody wanna be the first. Sometimes it's good to sit in the back.
All right.
You know, and then come forward, man. But we got a good little thing going on in the city, man, and in the state.
Yeah.
Both states, both Carolinas. You know, but we just got to all work together and cut all the BS out, man. That's really what's messing our growth up.
It's got the bottom, man.
Yeah, once you start getting out the street, and I never understood it, you start getting out the street and you making good money, what the hell you going back in the damn street for? That's backwards as hell.
I thought it was the hustle to get out the street.
Yeah, hustle to get out the street. That's as dumb as the ones from Ballantyne want to come to the hood. Y'all retarded too.
We kind of get to Ballantyne.
Yeah.
Kind of own some shit.
You know, so it just, the music scene down here good though, man. We got some nice artists coming from down here, man. We just need our city to support.
All right.
Need our states to support them, man. That's really about it.
Well, I'm. This is what I'm gonna say about it.
Say what you gotta say. We're making the track.
Tell them why you mad, son.
Yeah, I'm gonna sit up and say this.
Say that shit, man. Say it with your chest.
We got a lot of great talent just in the city, right?
Yeah.
We ain't gonna go outside the city. But the talent that we have is the same cats that'll shake your hand, but when they walk away from you, they got something to say about you.
You walk away, they stab you in your damn face.
My thing is, now, you a great business person. Great. That I've been with you long, not everybody. Great business person, and you're one hell of an artist. My thing is, if you was to say, I'm going to say this, what would make us grow is people, let me say this, I take a Prince song, boom. I want to start going to DJ. Let's just try to listen to my team first. Get a Prince song. Get a what, boom. Get a face to do visuals and go ahead to talk to some of these clubs. Get a Jay Breezy. I got my luck on, I got my Jay Breezy. I got Prince song. He going to do the event. Give me a bigger bull, I got me a host. Give me a Shadeezy, I got my Shadeezy right here. Give me, he doing his own thing, I don't know about him. Give me, I got Jay Breezy, Shadeezy, I got Luck Bar. Give me Black Bar. Create your own chicken circuit. Create your own chicken circuit. That we could go from Charlotte to Myrtle Beach, just in different towns, and different however you want to do it. And it's all ours. Because we all independent. We put up the bread, face, go talk to them. Boom, 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 boom. You make a all the visuals, you got cameras, Luck got cameras, we got everything. We got sound on some of the places we'll go and have sound. Now that's how you create and grow. Now you created your own tour.
You put it together, I'm with
you. But you gotta put a tour together of everybody that's cool and don't mind. Because with a tour, it goes with what it said. Even though we on tour, everybody got their own entourage. So the shit is gonna be like, boom, when we get to the place, the venue, all then we gotta do is pay for security.
Yeah, we all damn secure.
Nah, I'm gonna keep my business the way people.
Yeah,
you show people that you some hood jokers that can do this, guess what? Like you said, now promoters don't wanna get in and put us on a bigger platform. We just doing a chipper circuit.
And shout out to Pete Frank too, man.
That's why I was going to Pete Frank.
Yeah. Pete Frank is a beast, man. Y'all don't know who Pete Frank is. You're slipping, man. Pete Frank is.
Shout out Pete Frank, man.
You ain't going to hear nobody sound like Frank. Frank is Frank. Pete Frank is Pete Frank, man. So y'all go check him out, man, on YouTube. He just dropped some new stuff. We got a lot of.
We got an idea, man. Let's put this shit together and we make something work. But what y'all want to talk about, man? Say before we get up out of here, man. Or we making them track for y'all. Know y'all boys. We got busy shit going
free
on.
Free the steps, man. Step gang. Free all them boys, man. Yep, they're free everybody. Free my brothers. Anybody that's incarcerated should be incarcerated. Free y'all. Now, y'all rapists and booty bandits, y'all still be dead. But everybody else, you know, free the ones that need to be free.
All right.
Oh, what did I say?
Keep the rapists and the snitches where they're supposed to be.
With that being said, man, shout out to all my party punishers. Love y'all, even though I'm pop y'all. My drunk, my Ace Boom Coon DJ Fight, what's happening, baby? What's happening, baby? You gotta come outside and play, baby.
Fife will be there too on the 13th.
Yeah, Fife will be there on the 13th showing out. Do dirty.
Do dirty.
I know you got a free bottle, man.
Do dirty in love. Ain't nothing wrong with that. And to my homie, gorgeous Jersey. You know how we do.
Jersey, what's happening?
Nicky the King, Big House.
Nicky, what's up?
You already know. Dollar B, Mad Flex.
Hey, you know you love him. He just let my friend pull up.
Who?
Badala?
My little brother.
Shout out to Badala, man.
Badala always gonna be, he got to have the exclusives on his feet.
Shout out to Kevin Glover, man. Keep grinding.
Oh, Kevin Glover, you know I was getting to that. Oh, and also, remember, man, when you were the party punishers, stay connected. We Mackin and we trapped.
Y'all go to the YouTube pages, check them out. Party Punisher YouTube page. Go to the Step and Jit page. Go run his numbers up. 3 months, he already over 5,000 views. With no promotion, y'all go check some of that stuff out too, man. And don't forget to go check the movie out, God City, man. Go check that out, man.
A whole lot of bullshit, man. Hey, look, we back in the traffic, man. I appreciate my brothers coming through, man, giving me some of their time throughout the day on this lovely Friday, man. August 13th, 49th anniversary, hip-hop. Connect your well, son. Pull up, it's going down, man. Y'all already know who to get your info. The vendor spot, how that is, man, is going down, man. Reach out to the OG. Prince I. Stay connected, man. Mackin in traffic. The Shade Designer, we in this motherfucker, man. We're going to holler at y'all in a minute, man. Stay focused. Subscribe to the YouTube channel, Mackin in traffic, Love Bone Podcast. Hey, man, the Shade Designer open every day, man. We ship, we send, and we got the best price here. We take EBT. So how that is, man, it's going down like that. Whole lot of post shit. M time down, game time entertainment. We out this bitch, for real. Huh? Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Miss Fever. That was a good one.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Anybody want to donate before I end this live? Anybody want to donate for the back to school drive? Y'all can contact me or Kashana Sanders, which is my son's mother. Either one of us. We got asking for financial donations. If you can purchase the stuff.
I'm popping in the projects. Hood niggas, we do this. We ain't never had a shit. Came with all we conquer. Not a whole world. Fuck nigga, get my name right. You address me, nigga.
I ain't come for no 25.
I've been nine. I ain't come for no fuck shit. I rep mine. My foes up and my M down. Can you address me, nigga? Go up. Hey, Frank. If I ain't stay down 10 toes for the city, what the fuck you mean?
What the fuck you mean?
You know it stay true, still riding through the city, what the fuck you mean?
What the fuck you mean?
If I ain't low pressure with a badass bitch, what the fuck you mean?
What the fuck you mean?
Carolina being driven soft, you see it?
What the fuck you mean?
What the fuck you mean?
What the fuck you mean?
Huh?
What the fuck you mean?
What the fuck you mean?
What the fuck you mean?
Huh?
What the fuck you mean?
What the fuck you mean?
What the fuck you mean?
Huh?
What the fuck you mean?